Greetings, beautiful souls. Today's March 17, 2018. It's been a while. It's been a minute since I've been on Facebook Live as far as speaking. How's everyone doing today? Happy St. Patrick's Day. Happy day. Happy birthday if you're celebrating a birthday. Wherever you are in the world, I send you lots of peace. Send you lots of love. Send you lots of joy. And I'm here to share some wisdom today, so I'm going to start out with playing Alice in Wonderland. Do you hear it? The reason, because, you know, we're on a journey here. As you know, my name is Sharon Andrea, and I'm doing a book called Hello, Greetings, Danielle. Greetings, everyone. Thank you for joining me today. Greetings, Tavon. Greetings, everyone. So we're all Alice's in Wonderland, you know, we're all here on this journey. So I'm going to play Alice in Wonderland because we are on a journey here of great magnitude, great proportions. Bringing lots of love and joy back to the planet the way it was, the way it used to be. I remember. Do you remember? It was 555 just as I started because I looked at the clock. And so that's definitely a sign from spirit to do it. Movement and changes. Movements and changes. Movements and changes. Shifts. What is happening in shifts and consciousness and everything. Sometimes it's not easy for me to get on here as often because, you know, I too myself am going through my, shifting as well and processing and downloading and all of that stuff. So if anybody has any questions, I'm going to be sharing a dream that I had today. If anybody has any questions, please feel free to ask me questions. If I don't get to it, just, you know, put it back in again. I'm going to share this dream with you. I'm also going to read some past dreams that I've had before also in relation to what's happening. Today is the new moon in Pisces. And I know the usual theme, again, as always, is what we're doing to shift within ourselves. What's coming in, what we are transcending right now on the earth, because, you know, the earth is already shifting into higher dimensions, and so are we with our bodies, our minds, and our souls. So I wanted to start out with talking about what is going on, because I know there's a lot of people talking about the event. They're calling it the event. And I'm going to talk first about what's shown to me before I start reading anything, what I've been receiving as far as messages, what's been happening with my body as far as ascension experiences. I know many of you are having, ascension experiences or symptoms is what they call it. And it's just to really kind of bring it together collectively as well, because not everyone is going to be having the same experiences at the same time. So peace, Demetrius. You say, can I say your name? Yeah, is it Demetrius? Greetings, Demetrius. Happy day, happy day, happy day. So anyway, so I wanted to talk about what as far as one would say with the event, because, you know, as far as what I know, everything is still happening consciously, continuously. It's not where it's just one day that this is happening. This is happening, I would say, on a grander scale as we continue to ascend, as things continue to shift on the planet. And, you know, as far as the visions that I've had is where we're going to be receiving more codes coming in, you know, to do with our DNA. Our bodies are going to be going through more structures and changes. And it's to be in awareness of this, not to be in fear of this. It's just to be in awareness. And what this has to do, it has to do with how we're raising our vibration. And through this vibration, it's a wave of love, because we're really truly heading back into a space of true divine love. How we're connecting to each other, how we're living in sovereignty, in our own freedom, as well as the same time, how we're able to be together collectively and one with everything and one with all of life. That's what this is all about. And so as far as what has been shown to me, as far as this wave and the frequency that's coming in, is that we're now in a new moon in Pisces. There's also spring equinox, which has to do with new beginnings, you know, because it's spring in the northern hemisphere, and then it's going to be the fall in the southern hemisphere as far as on the earth plane. Also, Mercury is going into retrograde on the 23rd, and what Mercury represents is communication. Mercury also represents what we're doing as far as reviewing. It always represents a reviewing. Also, we are also connecting with all the information together and what we're doing as far as the changes where it's taking us with our lives and how, like I said before, how we're interconnecting, how we're ascending. And everybody's not going to be ascending at the same pace. Not everyone is going to be understanding of this, because there's some of us who are in a first wave. As far as whatever shifts that has been happening with me, I've been going through this on a grander scale since 2014, but I've been awakened within myself from I was 3 years young, because I always knew there was something that was going on. I just didn't know where to place it. I didn't know. I just felt strange, and I used to question things all the time. Everything to do with me, I question things. I don't just take everything for face value, not necessarily because somebody said anything to me, but because of my observation. My observation of what I've made with people around me, you know, and my surroundings in school, church, you know, family, everything that's changing around me from that time until now, until this present time. So anyway, as we're ascending on this new earth, what's happening is like what I, you know, say in the book, the return of the Garden of Eden. So everything is just going to seem brighter. Everything is going to feel. You're going to be feeling more into things. You're going to be feeling the energy of everything. The veil is thinner. We're going to start seeing some of our loved ones. You're going to be hearing things more. You know, some of us may not be able to see anything, and some of us will. I put it in a way like it's like the wheels are turning faster and faster and faster. Everything is just spinning faster and faster. The time is speeding up faster and faster. Everything that's on the other side from what we call those who that are not in the physical body is at a faster, you know, speed, at a faster frequency. That frequency is now templating onto the physical earth, and it's also coming through our bodies. So everything that's coming through on a more powerful scale with this solar flares, or they call it the solar energy that's coming from the central sun, that's transmuting from the actual sun that's coming through on the earth plane, and it's really, you know, coming through our bodies and everything, whether you're sleeping or awake, it doesn't matter. And to me, I don't subject it to just one day, as they say it's supposed to be coming tomorrow. It's been happening. It's just that the fact that it's been coming in a trickling way, and now what's coming is coming in like a burst of energy. I even told my son, David, how Spirit showed it to me. It's like a meteor that's, you know, hitting through to the earth. And then what happens is it's like sprinkling like raindrops. So it's like when the rain is about to begin, it starts to drizzle at first. As it starts to drizzle, then it starts to get a little harder with the rain. And then as you go from there progressing, it just becomes like a rain shower. And so it's something that you're going to feel. So some of you might feel more sleepy. You might feel a little spacey, because I've been feeling a little bit spacey, a little bit sleepy in a way. Not too sleepy, but more like I can't sleep. I haven't been able to sleep just as much like before. And lightheaded. I had some headaches yesterday. I also had, you know, still have heat coming through my body, just like as if you're having hot flashes. I was feeling nauseous. There's sometimes, some of you might feel some periods of nauseousness. I've been having knee pain. If some of you have been having anything else that's happening with your body, you know, pay attention to it and to see what it is that, you know, for you to understand what's going on with yourself. In most cases, it is ascension symptoms. If it's something that, you know, is in relation to signs and messages that you're seeing, then look it up and see what is going on around you. I know some people have contacted me with some ascension symptoms that they've been having, especially the ears ringing, the massive headaches, pain in their body. In some cases, you might have breakout, you know, on your skin, longer sleep patterns. Throat. I was even having issues going on with my throat, like as if I'm about to have the flu, which that's happened to me a few times. And that's usually like getting some throat chakra upgrades. Also my nose, sometimes my nose will get stuffy. Like I feel stuffiness in my nose, like I can't breathe. All of this is a part of what's happening with shifting and upgrades with my body. For me personally, because I like to talk about what's happening with me personally, those are some of the things that have been happening, which I'm used to it. But for me, I feel like as if I've been grounding more and more of my higher self. I've been getting like whenever something is about to happen, it's like I feel it coming before it happens within minutes now. So it's that's how much more rapidly I'm receiving messages. That's how much more I'm feeling into whatever is happening right now. And I feel at peace, you know, I feel a peacefulness within myself. I don't feel like, oh my God, this is like a doomsday. No, it's not like that. So that's why I wanted to be able to talk about this, because this has to do with a quantum shift in consciousness. It's a wave of love. It's healing for you, this wave that's happening right now. Peace, Patty. Peace. Peace, my sister. Greetings, Ron. Greetings. Anybody have any questions or anything you want to share, please feel free to share. And what we're doing too is that we're calling in higher timelines, because a lot of times I've still had some memories that have happened in our past lives, and then everything is just seeping into, I don't even say seeping, I should say more shifting out those timelines, and then you're able to make a choice to template newer, higher timelines. That's what, exactly what's coming on. And so this, the things that we've been experiencing as far as the vibration, the love, all this is a part of what it has to do with ascending on the earth. And where it's not where you're going into a different location physically, is that it's the earth is just shifting in from the fifth dimension and higher, and also whatever is here on the physical earth, what you're seeing. So it's not like as if we're going into other places. I've had my dreams already where galactic beings were connecting to me, and I was getting a lot of light energy coming through, and it was so peaceful and so beautiful. So, you know, it's like the veil is so thin, it's getting thinner and thinner, that everything is just coming together and integrating as one. And this has to do with how much we're expanding in consciousness. Some may say, well, I don't feel it, I don't see it, I don't know what's going on. So I want to tell you that one of the, you know, we're all here on different missions. We're all here on different purposes, okay? So my purpose is to bring things back together as one, to get it to that, to be into that place, okay? And yes, Patty, I'll get to that, your question. And how we're coming back to this place is in between yourself as the individual self. The individual self is raising itself in consciousness, raising itself in thoughts, frequencies, how we're bringing in new love, new higher divine love through ourselves and the connection we have to our twin flames, twin souls, if you're on a twin flame path or a twin soul path, and also to the collective, you know, for those who are in existence. Now, some of us may receive messages in different ways to how we're awakening, okay? And how we receive these messages, some of it might be through scriptures, the Bible. Some might be through songs. Some might be through just your spiritual path, your spiritual growth. Sometimes we may get the messages through the birds, different ways and different methods that the divine is using for us to awaken us, and also with each other. What makes this so special during this time, when someone says, well, why is it so much emphasis placed on this event and what's happening, is that it has been described that it's going to look like a rainbow. You might be able to see the colors itself in the physical aspect and not just internal, because there's internal things that are happening within you. And so every time each one of us awaken, and every time we awaken on different levels, and when I say different levels, I'm talking about different levels of consciousness, something that it's like you're like your memory is like, wait a minute, what does this mean? I'm seeing 555s. You're seeing 555s. You're seeing 444s. You're seeing 1111. Your soul is showing you how much you're integrating. You're seeing 1212. That's another portal, because we're in a portal right now. It's like even with everything, with Mercury being in retrograde, the new moon, St. Patrick's Day is significant also, because it represents green and connecting through with your heart. And it's almost like we're in a space and a vortex of a special kind. And what this means is that everything we are being propelled to work together within ourselves, because you can't ignore it. So you're going to keep seeing the signs. And each time if you see the signs and you're not paying attention, then spirit is going to bring it to you in another way through someone else. And this is, are you going to take the time to pay attention to these signs and the messages, what you're feeling inside? What are your dreams? Are you paying attention to your dreams? Are you paying attention to the messages? Because all of this is what's showing you what is truly awakening within you and how it relates to others. So you might have someone that's speaking about something to do with specific religion, backgrounds, or whatever. Each path, each way that someone is with this, it doesn't mean it's wrong. Yes, there's information out there that's changing and information that has been changed and distorted. So we're heading back to the truth, and then it's what feels right to you. And as long as it doesn't feel dogmatic and that you're not within your freedom, because the true path back to God has to do with what is happening within you and being empowered, knowing yourself, awakening to yourself, the truth, staying and being in your truth. Everything that's shifting, even in terms of the masculine energy, I've noticed, I'm paying attention to everything. I'm paying attention to what's happening with me, with my children, everyone who interacts with me, whether indirectly or directly. I've been noticing how the masculine, the ones who are in the male bodies especially, there's changes happening. Greetings, cuz. There are changes happening. I noticed that there's more surrender taking place. Even my son, Brandon, he has been more quiet. He's been having his own ascension symptoms. Your children are also experiencing it. There isn't any exception to any of this. He's been having the throat chakra stuff going on, not being able to sleep. He's up till 2, 3, 4 o'clock in the morning to get up to go to school the next day. Nothing is going to be ordinary anymore. Everything is shifting on the planet just as is. And, you know, think of it, because I took some notes because I didn't want to leave out anything. How, when you may say, I don't see anything. Because spirit wants us to start feeling into things, because that's where the true connection is coming in. As I've always stated that before, we're going to be at a place where we are connecting telepathically, because I'm even having the ability to be communicating telepathically with everyone around me, depending, because I can feel your thoughts. I could feel what you're going to say before you say it to me. If I'm not in communication with you, I'm still feeling what is coming through, because eventually we won't be talking on the telephone to communicate with one another. I've been seeing or hearing that, I would say going in later into, I think like by 2020, we're going to be communicating telepathically with each other. Sometimes, you know, it's like spirit always showed me, it's the things that are unseen that we have to count just as much as what's seen. So that means then, if you're feeling frustrated because you're not able to see what's going to happen, or you're not able to see the outcome of your circumstances, because spirit wants you to start coming from within your heart, connecting from within your heart, navigating from your heart to your mind. So that way you also know what's coming through energetically, what's coming through spiritually, and not just physically. This is how we're bringing both worlds together. That's what it means when we say, as above, so below. The earth is changing. We are changing. We're all going through drastic changes. Our bodies are starting to become crystalline. What does that mean? Look it up. I've spoken about it several times, about the nature of how our bodies are going to be changing. There are more people who are transitioning out of their physical body and going, you know, and they're choosing to ascend outside of their body. And that's because the intensity of the energy, you can feel the intensity of it. And in most cases, they're choosing to ascend. Some are also transitioning because they want to help, because this is a glorious moment. It's not a doomsday. This is the moment we've been waiting for. What has been written in scriptures, as I said, in Revelation, but not in a scary way. This is what is being said. I forgot the name that was used back then. Someone can help me out. It has to do with the, you know, whatever the great moments that has been written of what is happening to do with the earth catapulting and changing. Now, I had a dream. I'm going to go back, because spirit wants me to talk about the dreams that I've had, because I have like 5 books of dreams. When I used to write down my dreams, but now I record them. I record them verbally, because, you know, sometimes I'm going to like the typing thing. And this was back in August 28th, 2012. Now, if anybody knows, back in 2012, that was the time when they had written that it was going to be the end times, and what was going to end. And what was ending is the Piscean Age. We're in the Aquarian Age right now. And that means it's the end of old ways and old customs, old belief systems. A lot of belief systems are being restructured and broken down. And if you're still holding on to, oh, no, it has to be this way. Oh, no, I don't want to change. Oh, no, this is a, then you're going to start to feel more confusion. And that's what will happen to some people who are choosing not to ascend or choosing not to shift or choosing not to change their ways, holding on to hatred or separation consciousness. I had to like burst through so much elements of things, not just people around me, but also ancestors, because there's ancestral things that we're clearing. Okay. And some of it has to do with the mental slavery. Also, those who give their power away, those as far as the sexual distortions, those as far as the, you know, with control over relationships, the views on marriages and all of these things is what's shifting. There is no element of a God who is in control and power and hatred, because that's a human characteristic. So all these different belief systems also is what's breaking down. Also, what's happened during the course of your lineage with your parents, what your parents' views were on relationships. All these things is what, even though it said that, it's a burst of things that's happening now, it's been happening in increments anyway. Many of you have been separating from your family and friends because, you know, we are all being taken to the secret place of the Most High. You see, and that's within you and your connection to the divine. And there's some of us who are on the twin flame path. I am on a twin flame path. I am a twin soul, where I explained that is where you have the essence of the soul that is shared between two people, and it could be three people as well, only in the sense that there's aspects of the soul that starts to, have a particular frequency in terms of percentages, I would say. So like a twin flame match is like 100%, that represents the feminine principle and the masculine principle. And so we're here to template this higher divine love, as well as what is breaking down. What I've spoken about is breaking down in terms of the government structures. The religious structures are breaking down. Monetary system is breaking down. What else? There's people who are shifting as far as their jobs are concerned, because they're to be on their path with their passion. Everything and all of this is what relates together. Shifting with what we eat, what we speak, what we say. All of this put together is what represents what is breaking down, especially with this year being 2018, which represents 11, which is the master number. That is the master number that represents what's coming into alignment and to greater balance between masculine and feminine. It starts from within you, the inner aspect of you. And then those who are twins, the inner aspect of you reflects in the outer aspect through your divine masculine or your divine feminine, depending on what frequency that you carry. Okay, so I don't want to scatter all over the place. So what I wanted to just get back to again is what this expansion in consciousness means when it comes to this event that is happening. And it is not subjected, I said, to just one day, tomorrow, because it's already been happening. Everyone is feeling something. Everyone is experiencing something where you're coming to a greater space of humility, becoming more humble, knowing when to stand in your power, and knowing when to let go and let spirit, the universe, God, Yahweh, Jehovah, Jah, whatever name. You don't need to get caught up in the names, because spirit comes to each one of us in different ways, through different names, different cultures. We came down here incarnated in the physical body to know thyself, to awaken to your true self. And in order to awaken to your true self, you have to forget who you are so you remember who you are. Each one of us serve a purpose. Even Trump is God. And I said that to my friend. He said, no, that's not true. Yes, because if we didn't have him do what he does, how he is, then it wouldn't have you think finally and move and propel into shifting into your own power. And you have something to look at and say, I don't choose this. I don't choose that. This is, and you need something in place. This is how spirit worked it out. We designed it. How we worked it out to have something come in the opposite aspect of the self to come back into the greater aspect of the self. Because I'm going to speak scientifically as well. If you don't understand what I say, come back another time and you might relate to it. You see, because I don't just take it in the lower dimension. You know, when I do, if anybody knows, I do readings. And whenever I do readings, I'm going to take it to you from the higher perspective first. We cause ourselves to forget who we are so we can remember who we are. And as we incarnate into that, is to remember, which I love that book by Neil Donald Walsh, The Little Soul and the Sun. And he says, when we come down here, Will you remember me? Will you remember me? Are you going to remember yourselves? You see? And how we're going to remember ourselves is that we're going to have these signposts and different people are going to do different things. You know, whether we no labeling, whether good or bad or right or wrong, because there is no right or wrong. It just is. Everything is in its place. Everything is on its purpose. Everything is on its path. Everything is happening just the way it is. If you feel that you're going through the worst feeling and the worst experience in your life right now, I urge you to be in a space of gratitude. Be in a space of gratitude. The gratitude and the attitude of gratitude is what shifts things, no matter what. And think of how something else or someone else may be having it worse than you. And I still don't even want to use the word worse, just that it's just a myriad of experiences that we're having. We're having and seeing things and experiencing things from different perspectives. The all-encompassing, over-soul, over everything of the almighty cosmic center or galaxy chooses to know itself in myriad of ways and different experiences, different outcomes. And I say that in each moment, what is the message that you're receiving? And I don't say not to choose to honor your feelings, but also choose to understand where it's coming from and what does it mean. So anyway, I'm going to go into the dream I had back in August 28th, 2012. I dreamt I was driving on the road and the streets started to crack open like we were having an earthquake. I saw things falling all over the place and I thought to myself, this must be an Armageddon, the end of the world. And I was concerned about my children. I went home to sleep because I felt safe and I was told that I would be protected. And, you know, I remember that dream as clear as day. Every dream that I've ever had, I always remember them, you know, especially when it has an impact on me. And the Armageddon is already happening now. And it doesn't mean that it's where, I mean, in some cases, the earth is having the elements of things cracking wide open and we're having the hurricanes, the storms, the floods. All of these things represent the element of each part of the earth that is shifting because they carry energy from things that have happened in past lives as well. If there's a particular frequency of, I'll give you an example of indifference, hatred, chaos, it's going to break itself down because everything has to break itself down in order to build back up again. And so we're breaking down and rebuilding, and we're going in phases of this. So you have the moon phase. You also have the cycles that you're experiencing with the planets. So, you know, Jupiter's in Scorpio. That means that it's expanding. Mercury going in retrograde. That means that everything to do with communication and everything that we're reviewing is also being expanded. And we're coming back into that space to review what are the things that you need to let go of. What are the things that you're being shown that it's time to make a move. It's time to take action. That's where the masculine energy comes in. What part of you are you maybe needing to be in balance as far as your feminine aspect? Meaning that it's time to go into your intuition. It is time to tune in. It's time to feel into what is happening around you. And if you don't know what is happening, time to seek that out. And it's not about just getting up on a daily basis and moving through life and thinking that's all there is. Because every one of us, every single one of us have a purpose, whether it's singing, dancing, laughing, whatever, dog walking, nature, planting, whatever, speaking a spoken word, being quiet, writing a book. There's something more to you than what meets the eye. And this is what the energies are supporting, that for you to finally be on your path, especially those who are on their twin flame path, know that, which I never usually like to use the word mission, but what this is about you being on your path to where you feel, where it's taking you. Because as we are coming greater into these unions, the union of the soul, the union with you and your sacred partner, and your union with God, it all interrelates, it all comes together. So when I think of Armageddon, it is more of what is coming through with the veil becoming more thinner, the transparency, how, you know, with twin souls, we're able to feel and to hear thoughts and to feel the experiences of one another. It's like a phenomena. It's something that has never been discovered or written in greater detail, because it's not everything that's being I would say, explained as far as how this works. And the ones who understand this are the ones who are on that path. It doesn't mean that we're better, but just means that it's different in how it's expressed. And it means that we are following the guidance of what we are changing on this earth, that even if you've never heard of it or you've not experienced it, it doesn't mean that it's not taking place, because it's going to take place. I'm the one that's here that is leading the way when it comes to love, because I'm an expression of love. The colors and the aura around me is pink and purple and love and excitement and joy and laughter. Who says this journey is supposed to be dull and mundane? No. The expression of who I am as Sharon is expansive. And so everything that I am in this expression is reflecting back to me, to each and every soul, every living thing, everything and all things, all of life, including through my divine counterparts. My expression is so grand that I have two divine masculines, okay? This is showing up through me in the physical form as the goddess of who I am in all the elements of love, light, the water, everything, all the elements, you see? This is how I chose my path to be. And each and every one of us have a path, and is to overstand it into where it takes us and how it relates to the earth, how it relates to this event that is occurring right now, and how we show up as the rainbow. You know, so every particle of us that shines through us, it comes through as a rainbow. And that's why they're saying that the solar flares was coming through as like a rainbow, where you're actually physically seeing the rainbow, because each one of us that lights up like lighting up a Christmas tree, and it's like, ah, and that's how it feels. And it's powerful. And so many of you, I've been guided to also share, many of you are going to start to become more awaken and connected to this true essence of this powerful type of love, okay? And what it means is that you might even start to feel yourself being in love with someone else. And I don't mean being in love with someone else as far as having a sexual relationship. The higher state and the greater glory of God shows up through this type of love. And that means that you, just like how when you meet someone and you're attracted to them and you're like, oh my God, I feel this love, and you can't understand it. It's unexplainable. That's what's going to start to happen eventually with many of you. And you're going to try to be wondering, is it bad? Is it wrong? And it's just because it's not something that you were taught. It's not something you were taught in anything, because Spirit is bringing you on that path of feeling these type of connections and how we interrelate it with either with someone sacred, and then those who are also coming in your path, where you're also being in love with one another. It's like you're spinning like a spin top. I have spoken about this, how I had ascended out of my body. I was walking around like I was on stilts in the house. And it was such a great feeling. And when you're in that space, you don't care about the bills. You don't care about what's happening to Joe and Sally and Peter. You're not concerned about the little things that you might find that you want to complain about. You see what I'm saying? Whether this got done or this, and stressing yourself. Because where Spirit is taking us is in a place of where we're going to be in joy all the time. We're collapsing more of the duality experience. We're collapsing more of the separation consciousness, separating from one another, concerned about color of skin and culture and who's do this and who said that and all of that stuff. You see, because you'll find yourself also feeling isolated, and it's through this isolation is how you're going to find and discover yourself. That's how you're going to discover yourself, and what causes you to come to that place of shifting even more. Now, Patty had asked a very important question. I'm going to go back to her question, because I'm going to share a dream I had back. This was back in 2015. And I know that this question has asked, how does this event relate to twin souls? So let me just scroll back while I'm looking at more stuff here. Because one thing I want you to know is that as we are feeling this energy coming through our bodies, you're going to receive downloads that's going to, it's like you're going to be having your own personal messages, your own personal dreams. your own personal experiences. And then it's almost like each person is going to be connecting to someone that you'll be able to relate to it eventually. So you don't have to feel like as if you're alone on this, you know, with what you're going through and what's happening right now. And it's not to be afraid. It's to be, it's more to be in awe of it, you know, to be in awe of it. So anyway, I'm trying to look for Patty. Let me see where we go. Okay. So Patricia asks, what does this new moon have to do with the reunion of twin flames? Okay, well, I don't know, but it's, I don't feel that the new moon itself is just tied to the reunion of twin flames, because there are twin flames that are already coming into reunion already, from what I've heard. There's quite a few. And understand that those who are coming into reunion, it doesn't mean that you're just coming into reunion and then you're just happily ever after. Each moment of every day, we are shifting and integrating. We're integrating like you're releasing the old stuff, right, that doesn't serve, and then you're keeping some of the stuff that's going to serve humanity on a grander scale. And what's happening is, like, for me, like, what I found I was integrating whatever was happening in terms of this separation consciousness, those who were constantly on their path of separating with each other, with color of skin and religion and cultures and blah, 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 all of that stuff. Then I was dealing with what was shifting and integrating with the religious structures and the religious perceptions about things. Then there was things being shifted when it comes to the names and what names are used when it comes to the divine and who we are, okay? And what's important when it comes to the messages. So because as we are releasing the old stuff, and it also when it comes to releasing, the releasing also takes effect on the physical body. So another thing that we go to during this ascension is going to the toilet very often. You might be urinating and defecating more often. There's a lot of energy that's passing through your colon, going, exiting out of your body. And you're going to feel it within your body, and you're going to feel it within your soul at the same time. And then you're going to probably feel like you have to get some rest. You have to drink some water. I recommend to go outside if you can and walk on the ground, connect to nature. That will help you to ground it. Sometimes you might even be burping. That's because when I'm burping, I'm processing too at the same time. And so the way how it's shown to me is like, as we're going through these stages, when I'm looking up, it's because the spirit is showing it to me. As we're going through these stages and things are starting to be released out of the physical body also, okay? Some of you might find yourself getting taller. You might find your skin tone is changing also, okay? You may find yourself not wanting to eat foods for a while and just drinking water. Then you do that. Then you might find yourself just drinking the greens or certain type of meals. There's times when I've been eating and eating for the past few days, just eating, constantly eating. I mean, nonstop eating. So I allow myself to go through that. I don't stress over whether or not if I'm, because your body has to build up calories, protein, and all that stuff. Because each time you're feeling the heat coming through your body, your higher self is coming in more and more and more. And there are symptoms for those who are on the twin flame path where you're going to feel what your twin is also experiencing, and you're processing together because everything still interrelates. There's no separation when it comes to you and your twin. No separation at all. And this is where spirit wants us to keep showing up and staying in your truth, staying in your power. If you're staying in doubt whether you're a twin, or staying in doubt whether your twin is your twin, because I don't tell anybody who is your twin, then that person is going to also kind of feel like, oh, I don't think this is real, you know? And it's just like saying, well, do you believe in the divine? And even those who say, well, I don't believe in God, I don't believe, but you believe in something. You believe that there is something that is greater than what there is, than what is being shown, than what is being felt, that's what is being experienced. You're not finding it in books as much anymore. You're not finding it on the internet, because spirit wants you to go within. Go inside now. Time to go inside, and keep going inside as well. What feels right to you? I always say, if you start to feel something spark within you and you feel great, then you know that you're on the right track. You know that you're being guided constantly, daily, Okay, I don't feel the messages just stop just like that. There's no preferences here. There's no one that says, oh, I have it more. There are some who may be more advanced. They're advanced souls who've been here before that are receiving, because we are the way showers. I am one of those way showers to show the way and to light the way. Because for some of you who know who you are as the first wave, that you're being pushed to step into your knowing. Step into your space now. Stay strong with it. Don't back down because someone tells you you're saying that, oh, this is of the devil, or this is evil, or this is Illuminati. All of that stuff is put in place for two different reasons. One, you're testing yourself. Do you believe in your path? Do you believe who you are? Do you know? Are you listening to the divine? Are you listening to God? Every time I remember when I started out and my relatives, my aunts, and they were in place for me to get started. And even as things were shown to them and things were shown to me differently, they were in more fear. I wasn't. And I told them I loved them, but I had to keep going. And I keep going. That even if someone says, well, I don't believe this and I don't want to hear this, or they're in fear, it doesn't mean that you stop. You keep going. You keep on going. You stay in your truth. You stay in your power. You see, because it's like breaking yourself free and taking off those layers, because it's not serving you and it's not serving humanity anymore. Okay? And that's a part of what is also happening for some of you. Okay? And some of you are feeling it more intensely, because if you're in any resistance to something that you know in your heart, it's time to move on from a relationship. It's time to break away. It's time to end the karmic energy that's between you and someone, or whether it's a job that it's time to go, or a place that it's time to move, or a situation that's not serving you. And you know you're not doing it, then what spirit is going to do is that you're going to keep getting more things coming your way that's going to keep breaking it down, or it's going to feel stressful, or you feel like you're being locked in a box. There's some cases where you're feeling heaviness also with this, and that's your sign when it's time to make that change and to do what you know you're being guided to do. Okay, and to keep going within. Keep going within yourself. So now, in relation to the event with twin souls, I look at life and I look at things as how we come to a circle. There's always a circle, okay? A circle has neither a beginning nor an end. So as we refer to it in scripture as the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning, the end, the first, and the last. And that was spoken by Yeshua, also known as Jesus, many, many times. See, he says, I am this, I am that. That's where the I am has been spoken. It was spoken by me even before Yeshua was on the planet. Yes, I did speak of the I am, and I'm here again speaking of the I am. I am, I am not. I am me, and we are we. I am we. It comes together. We separated ourselves in the individuation of ourselves because we wanted to express ourselves as the God particles that we are, with this connection that we have to God and divine in the different ways of how we are expressing love. How much are you showing up as unconditional love? How much are you an expression of this unconditional love? Because that's what twins are here for also, twin souls. We're here to show and to demonstrate what unconditional love is all about. Are you living your life where you feel that you can only love someone if they do something for you? Are you living your life where you feel like if someone is in a relationship that you're choosing to judge their relationship, whether it's a same-sex relationship, whether or not it's someone who's going to be with two people or three people, or whether or not they are of a specific social status, that they have money or not? Are you basing this on what you see based on what someone else says, but you don't have all the information, so you're judging and you're criticizing and you're gossiping? You know, it's all these things that we're to, you know, for one to look at as far as unconditional love, you see, and being authentic, living authentically, being in your truth. You know, if you know that you're in a relationship and you're in your heart of hearts, you know, you feel the connection that you have to someone, but are you living a lie by being with someone else because you're afraid of what people might say? Are you in a relationship with someone because you are it was arranged and you're trying to please your family or your friends, or you're afraid of what someone might say? Or are you going to step into your truth and to your power? You see? Are you willing to let go of the things that you believe, the belief systems, and all of these things to show up as who you are as the God particle in that expression of God? Because it wasn't taught in church. It wasn't taught in your home. Because if your father is a pastor, or if you are a daughter of someone who's a deacon in church, see, it's all these things that, you know, is where you're being brought to that place. Are you going to be in your truth and your knowing? Are you going to stay there? Or are you going to be in fear because of what someone says, or because you were brought up from years and years and years of that programming of how you're supposed to be? Because you see, if you still choose to walk this path of being fake and not being your true self, or you're lying or trying to cover, because let me tell you something. What I find to be so amusing, but not haha, is when people come at me and say certain things and I see right through you. I see right through you, right through you. Like, it's like I see and I feel the energy. I feel the thoughts. I feel the vibration. This is what's amplifying on the earth. This is what the solar energies are all about. This is something that happened before, but it wasn't on a great scale during the Mayan civilization. Now, I don't go too much into history, but I still remember a little something, something, because I don't have to necessarily go into the books and what I look up, because a lot of times how I like to do it is I like to feel into what's being shown to me, and then I'm going to talk about it, and then spirit shows it to me and validates it. You see? And so we've tried to do this before, but not on this scale, because anything that had to do with the ascension, the previous time frame, is when people ascended out of their body and then totally disappeared, you see? But in this case, that's not what it's going to be. This ascension has to do with what's going to be seen, felt, heard, smell, every single aspect of your senses. But now what's happening is that this is about you connecting to your sixth sense. And guess what? There's a seventh sense and an eighth sense and a ninth sense. It goes on and on and on. So there's more senses that you're going to be connecting to. It's almost like having tentacles that's just going off like a light beam. And as we are connecting to these frequencies that are coming in on the earth right now, whether you're sleeping, whether you're awake, it doesn't matter where you are, it is constantly happening. It's just that whatever is coming in now is in the drum loads. How, what spirit showed to me is that between this, from the 17th to the 20th, that's when it's going to be magnified, as one would say, magnified. And you may, like I said, feel like you want to just lay down in the bed and sleep. You may feel like you want to jump up and down, you know. Just follow your inner guidance. Follow your inner guidance. So I'm going to read now this dream I had. This was February 14, 2015. And then, you know, Spirit just guided me what to look for. And it's in this is in relation, once again, to twin souls. Because as I was having this experience, each one of you who are on the twin flame path might be having or have had messages that are shown to you to know that you're here on a specific wondrous path here for God, because we chose and we were also asked and volunteered to come here to get things going, to get things started, okay? Because there are more people who are starting to become awakened and they're trying to understand their path and what is happening here. And remember that this is the journey to the self. And also the journey to the self, through the self, with others. It all comes together. It all interrelates. It all interrelates. So this is what I wrote here. And this was February 14, 2015, because it was right around, I think it was like January or February of 2015. That's when I realized I was on a twin soul path. My twin had found me June of 2014. I was already on my spiritual accelerated path from the time when my mom had transitioned back in 1999 anyway, but it propelled even more since my twin came into my life. And what it did is that it brought me through all the elements of things that were strange to me, and I didn't know what was going on, but I knew it was something spiritual. And for me, with me, I'm different because whenever things start to happen, I don't go into fear. All I do is I question. As I ask, then spirit shows me the answer. You see, and if you're also going through something that you might not be able to talk to every single person about this because they may say you're crazy or, but right now, the way how it's being shown to me is that everyone is feeling something. You may not understand the full effects of what this other person might be experiencing, but don't try to tell someone what they're not feeling or label it as something bad. No. And we've had to push through the elements of dark forces that have tried to stop this from happening, but it's too late now. We're in a place of glory and rejoicing that is coming from the other side. That's how I see it. And it's like I see the rainbow. I see the elements of how much more shifts are happening. I see how much more power is also being restored to some of us who are in integrity because, you know, everything that's coming together is what's coming together within integrity. It's not where some of you will get power back to start the chaos that happened in the beginning of time. That's why the story that talks about with the Noah's, you know, the flood on the earth with Noah's Ark, which is also, this is Atlantis. That's what that story is. You know, it's a story, but it was written in different, you know, ways of explaining it. It's the same story. It may not have the entire truth to it, but it still happened, you see? And so anything that is ascending, we're ascending and connecting intergalactically with other planets and our soul family, our galactic family. And it's almost like something that has been laying dormant, the dormant genes, the dormant DNA is now coming back alive again. That's why I knew watching the Black Panther movie, I knew right away that it was going to be an activating movie because it's for us to remember ourselves as the kings and queens that we are, the true gifts, and letting go of the slavery mentally, emotionally, physically, and aligning to your truth, aligning to your true power to come back to the to who you really are, who you really are. Because everything is coming together telepathically, telekinetically. All these powers are eventually coming back. Each one of us carry the elements of gifts and power that we've had before. But how it's shown to me is that in this time, it is going to be more enhanced. It's not going to be where it was the same like before. So interestingly, Spirit brought me to, the Avengers. The Avengers is coming out in April. And I said, wow, that's interesting because all of the superheroes are coming together, all of them. And I love it. It's exciting. And it's, and I'm not looking at it as a war. It's not a war. If it is a war, it's an internal war that you're having within yourself because it's not going to be any destruction or any destroying that's happening on the earth. And it, in terms of, you know, like I've said before, any elements of the earth that has been involved with earthquakes, tsunamis, flooding, that represents, you know, because Mother Earth is also ascending at the same time and aligning with everything that's shifting here with each and every one of us. That's what's happening as far as that is concerned. But as far as the earth being completely destroyed and start over again, no. We're just going through the cycles of death and rebirth. Death and rebirth. Some taking it on in a physical death and some it's an energetic death because there's a death of the old self is what's leaving. And you're being reborn again. Okay, and there, and it's a choice that you make whether you choose to let go, like I said, of the old ways and old stuff. And that means that if it does, if it's not pleasing to somebody, that's a part of that choice that you're making. But if you feel that you're not going to be in integrity with yourself and you know the truth about something, with about yourself, your path, who you are, something to change, it doesn't feel right, you're walking away, but then if you choose to want to go back to it, but you know the truth that that's not the path, then that's where you're going to be setting yourself up for more issues to occur in your life and to feel uncomfortable, okay? So now I'm going to go to the dream back in 2015. I had researched to find out about twin flames. It was February 4th, and I found out more about what happened and discovered that my twin and I truly are one. We started from the beginning of creation and we are the force together to keep things together, such as love, happiness, peace, joy, dancing, the sea, the ocean. He is the male aspect and I am the female aspect. I came from the sun and it is filled with light so bright. It felt scary to realize that He and I came from the higher dimensions of the Godhead. I'm still trying to remember within myself, but I feel it will be more revealed within itself when we meet physically and where this takes us. As we are rising even higher to that dimension, and the energy was even more powerful. And at that time when I came to that realization, my phone started to type and was like, I remember all this stuff was happening on the screen of the phone. It was a lot of energy. And I feel that at that point, there was a type of a kundalini energy that was coming through, because a part of this, and a lot of this has to do with opening up of your chakras, things that are lighting up within you, just like a Christmas tree. I started speaking in tongues. I started to hear music in my head. And that time I was awake for 48 hours. So that same picture that you see of me, where I put it together with myself as Nefertiti, that day when I took that picture, it was in that white blouse, was that same day that happened. I was awake for 48 hours. 48 hours. It was a lot of energy and a lot of strength that was coming from within me with all of that. So I'm going to read a little article to explain from scientifically what is happening to do with this geomagnetic storm. Okay, because as it is happening scientifically and it is happening physically and energetically, it is great to know what it means and having a much wider perspective and understanding of this. Okay, so according to the scientists, they said this storm is supposed to hit the Earth on March 18th. And it says, according to RAS graph, 3 days before the storm on March 14, 16, and 17, we will experience intense geomagnetic altercations. Once this storm reaches us on March 18, things might be a bit odd. It could disrupt GPS navigations, disrupt satellites, and even harm power grids across the globe. This will be the third since the beginning of this year to actually reach our planet. The other two took place on January 15th and February 19th. This geomagnetic storm is nothing to be afraid of and will probably only make it a little harder for you to sleep, which is true. Because I know the last time when we had the eclipse in August, I could not sleep. It was very, very intense. And then at the same time, my body was like, I wanted to sleep, but I couldn't sleep. That's what was happening. So it says some people may be affected, maybe more affected than others, but honestly, most of us don't even notice. Unless you are old or in bad health, you most likely will just think you're having a rough day. Now, a geomagnetic storm is a major disturbance of Earth's magnetosphere that occurs when there is a very efficient exchange of energy from the solar wind into the space environment surrounding Earth. These storms result from variations in the solar wind that produces major changes in the currents, plasmas, and fields in Earth's magnetosphere. The solar wind conditions that are effective for creating geomagnetic storms are sustained for several to many hours. Periods of high-speed solar wind, and most importantly, a southward-directed solar wind magnetic field opposite the direction of Earth's field at the day side of the magnetosphere. This condition is effective for transferring energy from the solar wind into Earth's magnetosphere. Now, I do know that I think it's Scotland and some other countries already have already seen it and videotaped it. I did put those videos in my timeline where you could see what it looks like. It's a beautiful colors, but I think most of the time they were seeing it during the nighttime. So it says the largest storms that result from these conditions are associated with solar coronal mass injections, where a billion tons or so of plasma from the sun with its embedded magnetic field arrives at Earth. It says it typically takes several days to arrive at Earth, but have been observed for some of the most intense storms to arrive in as short as 18 hours. Another solar wind disturbance that creates conditions favorable to geomagnetic storms is a high-speed solar wind into the slower solar wind in front and creating co-rotating interaction. So I just wanted to read just that little part there to do it, to explain scientifically, you know, what is coming. And like I said, this energy, it already has started. There are some people already starting to feel intensity around them. And there are some people who have had dreams already to do with it. Some people are referring to ships that are landing, which I've had dreams already to do with the ships. I dreamt that, I don't remember when it was I had the dream, but I think it was sometime, it was either last year or I mean the day before, last year or the year before, I dreamt that there was a big ship that landed, and people were running. Again, this dream, people running. They were running because, they were in fear because they didn't know. I was running too, and I stopped and I said, "Why am I running?" I knew this was gonna happen. And so people that were looking back and they saw that I stopped, they came towards me and they were trying to figure out what was going on. So it doesn't, now in all essence, I've been told that there are physical ships that will be landing, which some have in some places, and not necessarily tied to the event. Now I'm just talking in the future, in this moment of what is changing on the planet, that this is a part of what is happening to do with this ascension, okay? And in some cases, it's energetically because your light body is what is coming in more, and it's the connection that you're having to your light body, which entails as things are becoming more clear to you, as things are coming more fluid within you, that you're able to feel, to see, to know, to relate to the true nature of yourself, right? And how it all comes together. And as you're connecting yourself with your light body and also what's coming in with your DNA, because one thing I did hear is that the DNA that has been dormant, it's not just that that's coming back online, but also there's new elements of, not new elements, but DNA, new elements are coming through also to the body that is becoming activated with certain, depending on where you are on your journey. And you're going to know what effect it's going to have with you in relation to others, okay? And it's going to become even more activated for those who are on the twin flame path. And once again, that is for those that for those that it's coming in now is for those who are operating within a space of integrity, once again, okay? Because this is about how we're using our gifts and the power that we have to bring in and to help facilitate this joy and the changes, and it's a part of what brings on the things that break down. Because some of you who are also awakening know that your things will start to break down around you in your physical realm. Your phone might start to become more full. You might have to upgrade your phone. You might have to upgrade your routers. Your vehicles might break down, and you need to upgrade your vehicles. You might have stuff start to break down in your home. My refrigerator. A mouse went into it and the fridge broke down. I had to end up getting that fixed. So, and still it was a waking dream, and I looked it up, and it sure enough, it was in relation to changes. So much changes happening around you. So it's not to look be looked at in a negative way. It's just a part of whatever is happening within you that's changing and shifting. Everything that's in your external world will also shift with you at the same time. Even your pets might it will also go through shifts and changes. There might be illnesses that might come on. Some it might be temporary, some it might be for a longer time. And it's to stay as positive as you can. Stay as positive as you can. Take sea salt baths, like I've always recommended. The sea salt baths, if you are in a position to go to the sea, take baths at the sea as well. Ground yourself with the earth, hug a tree, walk on the grass. If you're not able to do that, walk, because even Spirit told me today, walk barefoot in the house, because usually I don't like to walk barefoot because I get cold and my feet get cold. But it has been extremely cold in New York for the past 2 days, even though spring is coming on Tuesday. So it's like the way I see it is that eventually everything is going to be a median temperature. You see, because everything that exists on the other side is what's also going to exist here. And it's like it becomes a median temperature. So as we are integrating everything that we have experienced, whatever it's getting rid of, whatever is staying, we're integrating the hot and the cold, the everything that's in this opposite. And when I say integrate, it means it's coming together, it's coming together, it's coming together, it's coming together. And then you might be getting rid of something that's not serving you, and then you're still coming together, coming together, coming together. And that includes the weather, that includes your emotions, coming into a greater emotional balance, and all of that is very important to pay attention to your thoughts and feelings and where, and allow yourself to feel, allow yourself to be in that expression and your truth. and then coming back into peace within yourself at the same time. That's very important. So now what I'm going to do, I'm also going to tell you about the current dream. So I went into the past, now I'm coming back current. So the dream I'm trying to remember because I didn't even get to record it yet, so I'm actually recording it for the first time right now. So I dreamt that I was in Jamaica. I was in Jamaica, and it was all of my ancestors, my aunts, and my mother's side of family. It was mostly based on my mother's side of family. Now, my family is from Manchester, Jamaica, right, on my mother's side. And this must have been like maybe the fourth dream that I've had to do with my ancestors and being in Jamaica, because the last other dream that I had, I was in Jamaica. My ancestors were in my grandmother's kitchen. And these were ancestors that I've never seen before. Some of them I've never met before. And I was introducing them to Charlize. And they had like a candle light for me. Because they're aware. They're in awareness. They're in awareness of my path. They're in awareness of all the shifting that I'm doing. Not only within me and for me, but for my family and everyone. Because each one of us that works through all the things that are healing and shifting, what happens is it's happening with them also. So in some cases, I also was shifting things that my mother experienced that I didn't, but it's a part of this ascension in what we're healing and bringing together energetically and coming into that physical space with what we're manifesting. So it's very important to pay attention once again to your dreams and what is happening within your family. If anything is occurring where it's like chaotic, know and understand that that energy that is occurring between you and that person or persons, it's energy that you're clearing, because we volunteer to come down here to shift and clear that energy. Because remember, energy cannot be destroyed. You can shift through the energy, you can transmute it, but it cannot be destroyed. And so as you're holding that space of truth and love and light, and coming from that greater perspective of what's being shown, you know, usually it's not going to last for a very long time with whatever pain or whatever you're processing, but know and remember that this is a divine thing that's happened here. You're on a divine purpose for what you are doing in order to get things going, you know, to do with your family and all we're coming together, even for with your soul family as well. So in the dream, as I was walking, It's like there was different tables that were set. And it's like as if there was a feast going on. My grandmother, my mother's side, was there. And she was speaking in Patois. And as she was doing that, I was walking with this very, very tall man. Oh my God, he was so tall. He looked like about maybe 7 feet tall. And when I see that in the dream, to me, it wasn't like anybody who was like, say, you know, on the regular human size. So that makes me feel like that was like somebody galactic. Okay. But what stood out the most is that I was walking and I was looking up, and it's like the way I was in this, the building, because I couldn't tell if I was in my grandmother's house, because, you know, in the country, it's like everything is on one level, you know, in the country. And in the dream now, we were elevated. It's like I was up, and it kind of reminded me of when I went on a cruise to Alaska. And, you know, it's like I'm on the ship is passing through. And then as I'm walking and looking up, I saw the mountains. And as I saw the mountains, it had snow on it. And I'm looking and I'm saying, wow, there's actually snow in Jamaica. I said, they look so beautiful. And that's what stood out the most for me in the dream, is seeing the snow. And it's not the first time that I've dreamt about snow, you know, and it was warm, you know, like a warm time frame. So I took the liberty of looking up, what does it mean to see snow on the mountaintops, and also what does it mean to dream of snow in a summer country, you know, warm climate. Okay, and so this is what it says, seeing snow on the mountaintops in the dream is a sign that you have a great ambition. It indicates that you could be achieving goals in life. The goals, though not yet achievable, could make it possible for people who would otherwise not respect it to do so. To climb a snow-covered mountain indicates your goals will be realized. Okay, so that's what it said with the dream. And so being that my ancestors were in the dream, I could feel, like I could go into the feeling, because I can't remember all the details, but I could feel the essence of the dream in and of itself is like telling me that it's full steam ahead and everything is coming together with my ancestors and in, you know, being in Jamaica, being on the island. And even though it was warm and snow was there at the same time, it shows me how the elements of the warm and the cold is coming together. See, it's coming together. And I didn't feel cold in the dream. I was just at peace. I was in awe. And my family were in joy, and everybody was around because a whole bunch of people. And that's how I felt with the dream. So interestingly, it says here, what does it mean to dream of snow in the summertime? It says snow falling in the summertime during a dream is a sign that you're going to experience pleasant surprises. It could be due to recent changes in your life to improve your situation. There are other changes that will occur that you had not foreseen, which is going to turn your life around to be in a better position. And that's what it said. So I know that even in all essence, that my life is changing. It's not, I'm not going to use the word it's about to change. It is changing. All of our lives are changing. And even as I have the dream, I can feel and know how everything is still coming together. I don't feel it, as much of an essence of separateness. Okay. And I could feel this peace within me to do with what's coming together, even with those who I am in contact with. And still I say that we're shifting. Things are just constantly shifting. We're in motion. Your soul is already in motion with things. How many of you find yourselves that you're trying to catch up to what you think you're going to do, but then you don't end up doing it? This is how spirit has us to be in a place of surrender. Surrender to what you think you're used to doing and used to being. And now pay attention to your soul self. Pay attention to what your soul is telling you. Pay attention to where your soul is taking you, because we're bringing both worlds together. Okay. Now I'm going to read something to you before I get to the other meaning of the spiritual meaning of snow. And this is what I wrote in notes. And this is the paper. And look how the paper is all torn, but I still have the notes. I still have the note. That time I used to do the writing thing. No, I'm not interested in writing because it's faster for me. And I prefer to hear and you feel the energy of what is spoken. Okay. And I wrote here, healing power comes through who are the Godheads, the demigods, aligned to biblical terms when we look at the Garden of Eden, you know, because that's what we're recreating, the Garden of Eden. Now, some say, well, it didn't really exist. And some say, yes, it is. And I say that each one of us know what we choose to experience as heaven, because heaven to me might not be the same heaven to you. But does it mean that yours is wrong or mine? No, it's just that's your perspective. It's your choice. It's your reality. So my reality is my Garden of Eden is the flowers, dancing, singing, joy, laughter, you know, all of this. And still, I understand that a part of the path is to go through things that are not of joy and laughter, but I don't stay down too low into the things that are not of joy and laughter. And I allow, is knowing that I allow it. And still at the same time, whatever I'm experiencing, I don't let that deter my my thoughts and what I am creating. You see, because as we are continuously in this creative space, okay, because everything that's being in creative space and in creation starts from the womb space, the womb center. Whether you're in the female body or the male body, we still are in this creative space, and we all descended, you know, through our mother's womb space, and we descended down to earth. Okay. And then now we're ascending while we are descended. And as we keep ascending and descending, because that's what Jacob's ladder represents, ascending and descending, we ended up speaking in tongues and different languages and stuff like that to confuse ourselves, because we had to demonstrate how are we going to come back into this greater glory again, this Garden of Eden again, through the confusion, through the chaos, right? Isn't that what's happening now on the earth? It appears as chaos. It appears as confusion. But remember again, take it higher. Through the chaos, you know, the chaos theory, we're now creating something through that. And we're giving birth to ourselves, and especially those in the female body, we're giving birth to a new humanity, a new part of you, and then it is extending out and it is connecting. So each one of you that are in the female body, the more that you are rising into your power, the more that you are awakening to your true goddess self, because that's what represents even more so the elements of the earth. Because the feminine principle had been missing for so long and it had been distorted. Remember too, those who are in the male bodies, you too also carry the essence of the feminine principle. You carry a part of that. You are that too as well. And as you remember yourself and remembering that part of you that is the feminine, because some of you also were females in past lives as well, you see, because this balance and this union starts from within you. Finding that peace and harmony within you, knowing how to navigate on both sides, seeing it and honoring your perspective, and then also seeing all the other perspectives of what is happening here. Okay, so as I go back to what I wrote here, I said, knowing God, the tree of life and judgment, a higher constant state, going back to reawakening, getting back to the proper relationship with God, opening parts to the God mind, okay? Because this is about connecting to the heart of God, the consciousness, the God consciousness. And it says here, balancing the left and the right brain. All have fallen asleep and time to wake up to a higher aspect of ourselves. Being in that fully awakened, living in that all the time. It's about being in this space all the time. All the time. Okay? The Buddha spoke about the pineal gland opening up the gates of heaven, the aspects of heaven. Go through that part of our mind to connect to God personally and to see and experience this on a daily basis. Going through higher aspects of our mind, direct connection to God, awakening within us. That's what I wrote. I know some of it may have seemed like it was just not choppy, but how interesting that I was able to go back and see what I wrote. And it wasn't even just what I wrote. This is something that I was channeling. That's what I was channeling. And so Spirit had me look up now the spiritual meaning of snow. And it's not the first time that I've had dreams to do with snow. I've had several dreams throughout the years to do with snow. And this is what it says here. Nothing is as it appears. What lies beneath the enchanting snowflakes floating gently from heaven to earth? From whence do these wild angels originate? Is this heaven speaking to us? Mysticism teaches that everything in the physical universe has a spiritual counterpart. That's right. Just as a teardrop is a manifestation of human emotion and anger is an expression of repressed energy, so physical phenomena actually evolve from and are a manifestation of a spiritual reality. Thus, snow is a channeled energy. It is a divine voice speaking to us through visual imagery so that we can experience it with our bodily senses. Meteorologists may perceive snow to be a result of pressure systems and precipitation levels. Physicists will recognize the subatomic particles that create snow, just like how we, you know, I was talking about the solar flares. So you have the scientific thing, and now we're looking at the spiritual, and you have the physical, and you have the emotional, and you have the astral aspect, you know, of yourself to what is happening here. How grand it is. Cannot limit to how the divine shows up, how we show up, how everything shows up, and see the grander picture, the grander scheme of all of this, right? Even through the dream, even through the snow. I still have snow. There's still snow on the ground outside here. I even heard that snow is falling in London right now, in the drumloads. And so the mystic sees the cosmic energy that snow manifests and the facets of our psychic that it illuminates. Let us explore the spirit within the snow. Water in all its forms is a symbol of knowledge. Descending water represents the transmission of knowledge from a higher to a lower place. Now see, I didn't read this before I said what I said. And I had no idea where I was going to be going with all of this from the time I started speaking. And still how Spirit shows it here through what was written here. Descending. I spoke about ascending and descending. Descending, we descended. We are the water. We are the elements of the earth as well. That's what your body makes up, all the elements, everything. And represents the transmission of knowledge. So we're bringing this, the knowledge, what's in the subconscious mind, what's in the ethers, what do I say? From a higher state to the lower state, to see it manifest in its physical form, to see it in from God sees itself, right? The whole universe sees itself in this grandest form in every entire cosmic energetic field that exists. And it chooses and desires to see itself as we're looking down and seeing the particles and seeing all the different areas, all the different perspectives, all the different experiences, all the different outcomes, right? Everything, all things, you see? And we couldn't do it just from being in just that one state. It's just like you can't see the whole picture just in the physical state alone. And you can't see everything just in the higher state because you just know what you know what you know. I've stated this before where you read something. You read about something. You hear about something. But have you experienced it? What are you feeling? What are you experiencing? 74 degrees in Atlanta? Wow. Not here in New York. It's 20 something. What a total opposite. And Atlanta and New York is like, what, 2-hour plane ride? 2-hour plane ride. So it's like everything is just coming together with the polarities, see? And that's what twin souls represent. It's like twin souls represent being together with the polarities, the similarities and the differences. It doesn't mean that you're exactly the same, but you connect on that same frequency, but you're an expression in two different ways. And in some cases, you still have similar aspect of the self. One can represent a shadow and what represents the opposite of the shadow. And sometimes we switch places, you see? And it's like, how do we integrate it? And that's what's happening is that we're integrating the masculine and the divine masculine. Let me rephrase that. The divine masculine and the divine feminine. We're bringing it together on both sides. And it's like doing this and being it and being at peace with it. Okay. And surrender to it. So even if you're seeing something that's a total opposite of what you didn't want to see, doesn't mean that the journey is over. It doesn't mean that something's not going to happen in your favor. No, it's really getting past that illusion. And that's where the solar flares is helping you to also get past the illusion. It's like the veil coming off. It's like you have on a pair of glasses, you know, like sunglasses. And you haven't taken it off for a very long time. And when you do take it off, it's kind of blinding. It's kind of like, oh no, I don't know if I want to hear this. Oh no, this is too much. Oh, I got to run from this. It's too intense. And you allow yourself to go through this at a gradual pace. See? So try not to negate it right away. Give yourself time to process through this. And ask questions. See, that's the other thing too, what this is all about. It's about seeking, asking, discovering, rediscovering, digging, searching. What's that movie with? Indiana Jones, The Crusades, The Alices in Wonderlands, you know? Going down deeper and deeper and deeper because this is where spirit is. You're going deeper and wider and higher, deeper, wider, higher. This is what it entails. The soul does not desire to stay in one place or one aspect of itself. It is desiring to be an expression, multifaceted, multidimensional. And this is what you are bringing on your multidimensional self. You're being activated for this to happen. And you can't stop the process from happening because it's the best for you. So the solar frequency is like ripping off the Band-Aid. So even if it's painful and something happens unexpected, this is a part of your journey. And you are remembering yourself more as to what this means for you and your journey. Okay, Patty, you said that if you're looking forward to opening your nail business, that's your focus. Your twin is a big dark shadow. And you're a big dark shadow too? Yes, hon. It's both ways. We have to look at everything to do with ourselves. Everything. Everything reflects. It really does reflect. At the moment when we start to feel something that is painful or confusing or frustrating, then, you know, as far as if it's something you see that you're, you know, that your twin is what we say doing, then we go within ourselves and say, okay, how does my twin show up as my shadow? Now, I'm going to give you my own example. Now, when I first started to really study what was going on with this twin flame journey, right? And I found it to be fascinating. I really do, because it depends how you look at it. Some people say, oh, it sucks. If you think it sucks, then you're going to keep experiencing it being sucks. I'm telling you how it works with the word. Be conscious of your verbiage. Be conscious of your words, because as you're speaking it out into existence, and especially if you're repeating it, it's going to keep showing up as that. So I look at this as adventurous, exciting, painful at times, yes, joyful, frustrating. Sometimes it gets to be frustrating. And I used to say, man, he works so much. He's like a workaholic, you know? But guess what? His workaholic, as I said it at that time, was still a reflection of me. Because I would be doing 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 things one time too. And I was like, wow, look at me. You see? So still be mindful, no matter what you feel about your twin or what they're doing. Anything that you place, of course, there's a difference between whether you're judging it or analyzing it or making observation of it. There is still something within you that's showing up because you share that same template and frequency as them. You do. Even if it shows up as the opposite. It's like, how do we show up ourselves as the person who's shy? Right? I'm shy, yes. Believe it or not, I'm shy, but I'm not as shy as I used to be. And I know when it's time for me to step into my masculine power and to speak up. And then I know when it's time to come back into my feminine energy and come back into my quietness. And I don't say being feminine means quiet, because there's some, you know, mass males or masculine that are quiet, but just knowing how to be in balance with it, you see? And being at peace, because no matter what happens when it comes to this twin flame path, no matter what happens when you're working on yourself, when you're still being yourself and you're still being authentic and in your own space of what you know, when you know, there isn't anything on this earth that can change that. Nothing. It is going to be. It is. It's so, and so it is. That's it. I say, it's like, that's it. It is written. It has been foretold. That's it. See? And it is to still get past any of that illusion into thinking that they're separate, because they're not. Not now, not ever. You know, I've seen it happen so many times when we may try to forget and think that, oh, I don't want to be bothered. Oh, I'm going to get on with my life. And then you can't, because as you walk out the door, there goes a name popping up, or a synchronization popping up, or a synchronicity, whatever you call, you say the word, you know, or a song. You hear a song. It's something. And then that's still God speaking to you. That's still God communicating with you. That's still, and God is communicating to you through them and with them. And when you come to that place of surrender, then you no longer feel as much pain. You no longer feel as if nothing's happening, because it is all happening within you. Your heart opens up more. You're holding a space of unconditional love. You're letting go of any detachments. You're letting go of how you think you want things to be. Or you're letting go of the suddenness of things, because it sometimes it may come across suddenly. Sometimes it may come across as nothing, like zero, like nothing is happening, like the void. Because I had been seeing 999s, and then I started to see zeros. Zeros, again, that circle, the zero represents the beginning, the end, what comes into a completion, and then it doesn't stay in an absolute completion, because as we keep ascending, we're still going to be going through another phase. Even when you come physically together with your twin, even for those who may be living with them or getting married to, whatever the case may be, the journey doesn't stop there. We are always forever going to be in movement and shifting. This is an exciting time where, as I experience what I experience where I am, you're going to have another experience where you are in a different way. It's not going to come across in the same way, but there's going to be similarities and there might be differences. Does that mean that we're enemies? No, it just means that it's different. It's still God, still God, still the universe, still the cosmos, still the galactics, still us, me, you, we, all of us. The more we allow ourselves to let go of the labels, the names, the attachments, the outcomes, the circumstances, the differences, all these things, and just stay in that space of love, the freer you feel, the more powerful you feel, the more, how do I say, you feel like you're in a greater space of joy and peace and like being childlike and free, you see? And it's no longer heavy for you. It's no longer heavy for you. You see? But if you still keep focused on the pain, the sorrow, the disadvantages, blah, blah, you know, all these different things, it can be a little bit more challenging for you to be able to bring things into manifestation. And it's not only that you're bringing it in manifestation. You're bringing things into manifestation, but you're also having it stay in a peaceful state. You know, how many times if you have anyone created things into their reality to find themselves feeling like as if it's all crumbling all over the place and you're trying to bring it back together again, and it doesn't seem to hold into its space. Now, there are some cases where that's still happening because maybe it depends on your path and what you're demonstrating here. What you could be either fighting for, changing, you know, like how I say the structures all around us is changing, the government, the banking system, the monetary system, you know, educational system is also breaking down, you know, everything, every single thing, you know, and what it means for us and these changes, because we cannot expect that we're going to be recreating our gardens and recreating everything that we desire to experience in this physical body and have these old things in place where we're feeling like we're drained and pulled and taken advantage of and all these things. No, it's just not going to exist. It is not going to exist. No, under no circumstances. Time is speeding up. Why do you think? This is a part of what feels like crunch time. You know, that's how it feels. So I wanted to just finish off with what I was reading, the spiritual meaning of snow, as it says, water flowing downward, right? Thus describes God's way of transmitting his energy to us and represents the conduit through which our material existence and God interact. The purpose of existence is to create unity between God and man so that we in our limited material existence can become integrated and unified in an intimate and equal relationship with God. Notice the word intimate. You're creating intimacy right now with God. Intimacy with your twin. Intimacy with the flowers. Being able to see it and feel it and breathe it and say, ah, wonder, beauty. Oh, I feel this love regardless of my outer circumstances. Oh, I feel the changes. It may not be how I want it to be right now. It may not be what I expect, or I'm not sure. Maybe it's shown to you. But all you know is that this intimacy that you have with God and others and everything is what's leading you into that path of what you are creating. And we are just the co-creators of this grander scheme of things. And it is coming together as it falls apart. Okay? And I call it the dangling of the carrot when the concept of the twin flame and the twin soul, what it means, because it makes you want to go after something that you've always desired, that you've always wanted, to feel this type of love, to feel this type of connection. And as you feel it, as you've never had it before, then something starts to change. You see? And so for us to come to that place of what we have with this, we got to let go of some things. And that's where the elements of all of this comes into play. So it's either fire is going to burn something, water is going to drown it, remove it out of that space, or you're going to have the elements of the sun that shines on it, shines through the darkness, you know, as we go through the, you know, have gone through some darkness, have gone through some shadow parts of ourselves that we have to look at. Can't run away from it, because then it's going to come up again and again and again and again, you see, and not to judge it, just to be in observance of it. Allow yourself to move through those elements. And then you have the air. Something might just blow your way. Like, where the heck you come from? Where is this? Where did this come? What is this? What is this? The storms, the hurricanes, the tornadoes, you know, which represents the aspect of air that's going to sweep up all the elements of things that don't serve you, you know. It may seem like it causes destruction, and it's going to suck up some of the stuff that doesn't serve you, and you're going to feel it right here. See? So there's the actual storms that the earth is experiencing, and then there's the ones that you're also feeling inside. It feels like a storm. It feels chaotic. It is painful. It's heavy. Take a deep breath and blow it out. Go watch a movie. Sing, dance if you can, comedy. I recommend when you're ready, because you might not want to do it right away. You might not. But know that as you are processing through these things, that there's something greater that is happening within you. There's something greater that is happening within you. So as we are unifying ourselves to become integrated and unified, okay, with ourselves and God and our twins, if you're on that path, right? We're achieving this, and it is neither divine nor human. It can and it can be compromised. Unity achieved on God's terms would annihilate our identities, our existence. Can we, our egos, vanities, and needs coexist with God, who is infinite, uncontained, and undefined? And unity attained on our material, finite terms would compromise God, because he would have to limit himself to our existence. If water, the divine wisdom, were to flow continuously, it would totally submerge and obliterate, not allowing space for any other existence. So water flows in various measures to allow for the transmission to be internalized. Sometimes water flows as rain, and sometimes it freezes to different degrees, producing snow, hail, or sleet, which are all metaphors for the teacher monitoring and transforming the flow into forms that the student can contain and assimilate. So that's what it is. It's like we're assimilating knowledge, wisdom, power, true power. We're assimilating love. The love and all of this power, but the power that's coming into balance is what transmute out the darkness, the shadows, coming back to love. See? And we're assimilating all the elements, the water, the air, the snow, everything is assimilating and assimilating. The cold, the hot, all the dichotomies, all the things that have existed throughout millenniums that represent the polarity and the opposite. Because you see, on the other side, where our loved ones reside, those who are out of the physical bodies, it's called the realm of absoluteness. Everything is in its oneness space anyway. And so that oneness space that exists on the other side is what's integrating and assimilating on the earth, within the earth, okay? And it's a huge transformation with this, a huge transformation. So rain, it says, is a transmission that is more on divine terms. Admittedly, it falls in drops, which symbolizes some level of contraction, but it flows continuously like a stream of information, retaining its fluidity, and it's absorbed quickly into the earth. And isn't that how I described the geomagnetic storm, is that how Spirit showed it to me? It's going to come in like it's raining, you know, it's coming like particles and sprinkles first. And then it may seem as it comes in waves and like a meteor, you know, and that's how I see it. Now it says here, ice, on the other hand, is a transmission that is more on the recipient's terms. The information has solidified into a compact state so that the student can internalize it. The flow has ceased and turned into a solid form, so the student is not overwhelmed by the continuous flow of new ideas. Snow is an intermediary state between fluid water and solid ice. In order to appreciate the spiritual implications of this, we need to examine the properties of snow. A snowflake needs at least two components in order to form. In addition, obviously, to cold air, it requires water droplets, vapor, and a nucleus. The nucleus is made up of dust, minerals, and other microcosmic particles in the air. A snowflake is formed when water takes shape around these microcosmic particles and the cold air turns it into ice crystals. Thus, snow has two components, water and earth. Earth being the particles and the water being the droplets. Earth is the material world without any recognition of godliness. Water is the knowledge of God, divine energy without any containers. Thus, snow, being half heaven and half earth, provides the perfect intermediary between these two worlds. Snow consists of separate snowflakes that are actually independent properties, each comprised of about 100 ice crystals. Snowflakes cling to each other, but they are not intrinsically one. In contrast, water is one unified entity, because, you know, water, it changes form. It can turn to ice, it can turn to snow, and it's still one. And we are the ocean. We are the drops of the ocean. We are still one. We may have separated into different aspects, because when I think about the Avengers, you know, it's like they all have different gifts. They all have different powers. And imagine what that's going to be like when all those, and by the way, all those powers that exist with the Avengers, it's true. That's exactly what it's going to be like eventually. Not where it's going to be where there's anyone that's abusing this power, okay? Not in that way. And so when you think about that power that comes through the elements of who you are, and then the other divine gifts that are coming from, you know, because each one of us have incarnated on different planets and we've all gathered up experiences from these different planets. So I'm going to go scientific right now. And as we gathered up all those experiences and powers that we've had on those planets, we're bringing it now. And it's exciting. We're bringing it now together and, you know, as one, integrating all those powers. You see, I think about A Wrinkle in Time. Sorry if I have to be a spoiler, where they were flying. They were flying in their human bodies, which is what's going to happen. And all they did was they took in that energy of flying and how it made them feel, feeling free and looking at the amazement of the earth and how beautiful it is and the colors. And then the it showed up, which was represents the darkness, and the young man fell. He fell down just from seeing the darkness, what they call the it. And see, the it is still in place. The darkness, different elements of darkness. We have the shadow that represents the darkness, which is the shadow within you, the opposite of you. Then you have the darkness, that which goes against itself, the polarity. Okay. And he fell because of fear, being in fear. And so that fear had him fall down and he forgot himself. He forgot his powers. He forgot to stay focused on who he was. And instead he descended down from fear. Okay. Which was still done on purpose from the beginning of time. You know, we fell from grace. We descended in consciousness. And as we descended in consciousness, all the different elements of things started to develop, you know, with, you know, the religion, the education, the cultural differences, the different races, different elements of speaking, you know, everything, the whole nine yards. I want to go into all the details. And as we did that, there was the fear that was developed, you know, fear of this, fear of dying, fear of love, fear of all different things, you know, fear of the unknown. And when that happened, we forgot who we were. And some of us came in remembering a little bit more. Like I said, I remembered when I was three. I just knew something was up. I knew something. And I used to just have my conversations with God, and money used to just fall out the sky and just land right at my feet. I'm like, oh my God. It was just always, everything was amazing for me when I was a little girl. Everything's questioning, feeling things, seeing spirit, everything, you know. And my mom knew that about me. And I'm so grateful for her because she never, ever, ever rejected me. She knew I had gifts, and we were all dreamers in the family, always having dreams, always getting messages. And, you know, it's like, I'm glad that I stayed on path during, you know, that whole entire time, because it is that part of me that knew I was going to find the answer. Somehow the answer was going to be shown to me. Somehow I'm going to get to the bottom of this and come back to the top. You know, every time I remember when I went to go to Sunday school, and I was rebelling over that. I remember I was rebelling. I didn't want to go because I was like, no, I don't want to go because if something didn't feel right. And I'm grateful that I did go when I did, because I needed to have the information and the background to be able to speak to others who are speaking that language. Just like as much as children, you know, I speak the children's language. I understand who they are, where they come from. I speak the language of those who are older. I speak the language of the teenagers. I speak the language of the animals. They're drawn to me. You know, everything. So I don't discriminate. I don't push it away, because I know in all things, it's still God. In all things, I give thanks. You know, the dream I had where it, once again, it was snow on the ground. And I went into my children's bathroom and there was water all around. And I went into my room. And when I looked outside of my backyard, I saw all walks of life. Everybody, celebrities, church people, every single person was there. And I was so happy. And I was like, oh my God, there's a party going on. And I wasn't, and I didn't know. And I said, I had to go get ready and get dressed. And I said in the dream, oh my goodness, I'm going to go outside because I want to dance, and I'm going to dance on the other side. It would almost seem like as if I was saying, am I going to die to go to the other side and go dance? No, I'm bringing both worlds together. I'm bringing my world, our world. We're all bringing this together. And I think of the movie, you know, the Matrix Revolutions, you know, and it is a revolution. It's a revolution, evolution of the soul, and how we're dancing through this. And it's an inner dance. You know, you feel it. Those who are on the twin flame path, you know what that dance is like. It's the most intense, out of this world, invigorating, of course, depending on how you look at it. Because like I said, it's all in perspective. And what it does for you, what it does for you, what it does for me, what it does for all of us, as we continue to shift, as we continue to move and propel forward, as we bring in our warrior selves, our goddess selves, our God selves on that, in that aspect. And this is how much the earth is still, we're still on this ride. We're on this ride. We're on this journey. You can't, you know, some may want to choose to come off, and some of us are going to stay to be with this all the way. There's no ending. Like say, oh, is this going to be to the end? Is there a point where it just ends and we're just not doing this? No, we're going to be constantly doing this, constantly. So we might as well get used to it. If you choose to stay and to observe, because it's in this observation of the self that you see yourself in this physical and your spiritual light body that's coming in, that is showing up as the greater, grander version of you, as that particle of the greater aspect of the is. Because remember, the is not everything, see? And so in that wrinkle of time, we have descended, fell down from, you know, the darkness, and now we're rising through the darkness back to the light. Okay? And as we're ascending back to the light, we will no longer have to be in fear. Fear not. False evidence appearing real. And so I just say, keep on keeping on, and keep that part of yourself in strength and power and truth. You cannot go wrong with that. You'll go right. And of course, if you go wrong, that's still okay. And it's no wrong and right. Like I said, there's no wrong and right. So I'm just going to finish reading what I said here, because I know I'll go off and on, because, you know, this is like, It's so exciting for me. And like I said, it's exciting for me because I feel the whole thing. I see the whole picture. And it's like, even if I try to go into the physical 3D stuff, I can't stay there too long because I go right back high again. I'm like, oh my God, this is what's happening. And I just allow myself to be in that space, to be in that space of delight, like a child. Because if you cannot be like a child through this process, if you cannot be ready yet for this joy, then that means you're not quite ready. And if you're not ready, you're not ready. But all I know is that everything is speeding up where everyone else is starting to feel, because it's in this space of joy and in this space of being like a child and letting go, just like children, when they're in their joy, they're not thinking about whether you like what they're doing. They're going to go behind your back and still jump up on the couch and do this and that. And I say, go jump up on your couch, go run, go play, go skip. And you say, but I can't do that because I'm going through this, I'm going through that. I know it's temporary. It's temporary. It's temporary. You're temporal. You're in movement. Your soul is in movement all the time. You're not resting in peace. You're staying in power. Everybody is in power everywhere. But it's for you to tap into it. It's for you to remember it. Okay? It's for you to awaken yourself every single step of the way. And as you awaken to yourself, you're lighting the way not only for yourself, but for others. And not being in fear of it, okay? Because, you know, when I think about people talking about, we don't need to talk about being a twin, and I don't need to do, why? Because this is of God. This God is not in secret. God is in the open. This is in the open. This is all, everything is being revealed. This is the revelation. This is the revelation. This is what's being revealed. You said, like you said, if you're not ready. Yep, that's right, Patty. If the person's not ready, they're not ready. And then even if you're not ready, the divine is making you ready. Because, you know, it's like that story in the scriptures of those who were being prepared with the virgin lamps. The virgins were being prepared with the virgin lamps and the brides and becoming the bride. And this bride, the brides that, some of us are becoming, is the ones that are coming into that integration with the Christ consciousness, okay? Because it's not waiting on you. It is happening anyway. And there are some souls who may say, well, I'm not ready. This is too much for me. And they may choose and decide to leave out of their bodies, like I said before. So you may find yourselves experiencing more sudden deaths in your family. I mean, just within the past 2 weeks, I've heard about so many deaths. And it's young and old. It doesn't matter. And it's either through some getting killed or they just leave, just leaving just like that. Someone that I talked to, she told me her cousin, only 42, just passed away in her sleep. They don't even know what happened. So there's some who are on soul agreements and have soul contracts and are choosing to leave. They're choosing to leave. They're choosing to ascend outside of their body and not really here on the physical plane. And there are times, I mean, don't think that it's always, you know, hunky-dory, as one would say. For me, there's times when I'm like, oh, I don't know. It's like, do I want to keep going? And that's like, you know, God was very clever to make sure I had these kids. Because sometimes I feel like, do I want to go through this anymore? Because it can be intense. It can get to be, you know, a taxing on the body. But it's temporary. And it's okay if you feel that way. There's no wrong way into thinking if you do feel that way. It's just that you just don't stay too long in that thought process. Reach out to someone or someone who would understand your path and your journey. When you go through this, it's going to seem, you know, because there's some people who, you know, you might be listening to this, that you're just starting to become awakened and the information can feel overwhelming. I know I'm talking longer than usual, but I want to get everything out as much as possible so you can always come back and listen to this again, because this is not just subjected to just for tomorrow. Whatever I'm speaking now, it's still going to be ongoing, because each time we go through a moon phase or what's shifting with the planets, it's just going to just be increasing. So it's not just subjected to one time. Yes, I know that there's a specific event from what I heard where everything is just going to practically just fall off at one time. And then you're going to start to see your world look different, you know, around you. But not everyone is going to see the same thing. And there's some where they're just going to be leaving, you know, they're going to go back to the light, going back to the Godhead. And Spirit has always told me that there's some who may at the last minute say, oh, you know, I feel something and something feels strange and it's not the same. Or even today, I was going through my Instagram and I noticed that Snoop Dogg did a gospel album. I'm like, wow, that's very interesting. From being a Rasta, and then now he's doing a gospel album. And so I didn't look at it to say, oh, is he getting into all this religion thing? No, I look at it that every person is awakening from some way, somehow, okay? And their truth is leading them to more truth and higher truth. So it's going to start in some way from a cycle of something changing in their lives, how they've led their lives. And it's not to be judged until when they decide to change again and say, you know what, this doesn't serve me anymore. I want to move into another direction. I want to feel more. And then you see someone else also experiencing a different type of joy or a different element of something else. And it's that person to say, you know what, maybe there is something more. Because you see, the more I know that the more one is open to life, open to what the truth is. And when I say the truth is, of course, that could be subjective because one person's truth may not be truth for another. If it feels right, that's how you know if it feels right. Does it feel right for you? Does it resonate with you? How does it make you feel? If you are in any type of religious or political or any of those structures that you feel disempowered or you feel like you can't be yourself, then time to get out of Dodge. It's not for you anymore. Or at least you don't put in too much into it and to be on your path to where you're being led to the divine, that divinity that you have, that relationship, that intimacy that you have with God. It's not for anyone to tell you how it should be. It doesn't mean you have to be at a specific location at a specific day every week or a day to say that that's what leads you to it. You see? It is for you to dwell in that secret place of the Most High and where it takes you, regardless of what it is, because you are that individual expression of that. So anyway, I don't know if anybody else has any more questions or comments. I wanted to at least read lastly about the, this was an article that I did post on my timeline, but there's some that probably didn't read it. So, and it has to do with the event. It's called From Sonata, The Event Is Coming. And this was posted on March 10th by Adelaide Adrini. And this is what she wrote. I'm assuming it's a she. My dearest friends, it is with great delight, joy, and immense love that I bring you the biggest update in recent times. The time is now for all who are ready to return to love, because that's what this is, returning to love. You, my beloved lightworkers, have been patiently waiting for this for a long time, for a magnificent, miraculous event such as this one can only occur at the perfect divine timing. We, the company of heaven, must wait until the frequency of light on planet Earth is high enough to catalyze, trigger the event, and until everyone who has, at a higher level, decided to ascend is sufficiently ready. Which, of course, is what I mentioned, that we're at a time now. The Spirit is showing me where a lot of us, many, many, many of us on different parts of the earth that are awakening and awakened. And we are templating more higher frequency, light codes, however you want to word it. And because of that, this is what is allowing the solar energy to come through more. You see, because Spirit told me that even for me, I know that I'm supposed to be doing things on a cosmic higher level when it comes to speaking and stuff, but it's just not time for certain things to take place because certain people have to reach a certain level of consciousness. That's the reason why some twins, why you're not together with your twin soul as yet, because there are certain parts that we're placed on the earth, like, But either way, we're templated in certain parts of the earth where that grid, that's it. That's the word I was looking for, the grid. Thank you, Spirit. That grid is placed. And as this grid is lighting up, I think about this game, you know, where they plug in the light. And that's exactly how they're viewing us from the higher beings are viewing us. Because some of us are on the grid. Some of us are not on the grid lighted up as yet. But now what's happening is that this grid is lighting up more and more and more. And as that is happening, every person is going through shifts within themselves that they're able to attain this light or to view it or to understand it, to feel it within themselves and connecting to it. Otherwise, that's why they feel like they got to pull away. They got to wait to kind of, you know, connect to it, understand it, transmute what they need to transmute. Then that's when you might end up reconnecting back with that person again. In some cases, there's some things that are just completely going away from you. And it's to allow and to just let it go because it is no longer serving you. And they may come back. And so it's going in stages and intervals up and down. And some may come back down again. And you're going up higher in consciousness. It's about consciousness. And then that person meets you there again. And then you end up like pulling away. Because it's not about where we're supposed to be on burnout like before in the past lives where you're constantly like you're on a pulpit preaching. No, this is about you connecting to the divine, to God, to Jah, to Yahweh, to the higher being and connecting to who you are and where you are placing yourself in this new time space continuum. You see, where we're not running to others anymore for the answers, you know, that you're allowing the answers to flow through you and being in your sovereignty as we're all living in a sovereign type of setting with one another. That's what this is about. And being in joy and love. That's not left out of the equation at all. Being with who we love. Being in love. Okay. And that space is staying there. And not where we constantly have to be looking over our shoulders or what we can't have or be and do. No, not anymore. So it says, we have all worked hard for this massive project for thousands of earth years. For what felt like eons in your linear concept of time. The amount of highly evolved light beings participating in this grand adventure number in the trillions, located on both sides of the realms, physical and non-physical, and you are among them. Your dedication, hard work, courage, perseverance, immense victories over seemingly impossible to overcome challenges, and all the experiences that you had gone through in current and past lives have brought you right to this point. They have made you ready. And the time is now for all of you to reap the rewards. What do you mean, you know, do you want to suffer? Do you want to be, I'm not saying you're going to suffer, but that's why I said it's a choice because you can choose who you want to be, who you choose to be, regardless of the elements of what's happening around you. It does become a choice. Now she says here, let us begin with the following question. What is this great event? You may have heard of the event mentioned in passing, in other messages, blogs, or books. And for some of you, this may be the first time you have come across this information. Simply put, the event is a singular, cosmic, completely visible, planetary scale explosion of divine light and love on Earth. These powerful waves of divine light and love will come straight from God's source, channeled through the great central sun, which is also known as the planet Sirius, which that's where I'm from, S-I-R-I-U-S. Oh, thank you, Jessely. Thank you, thank you. I love you. I remember you. I didn't forget you. And it says here, they will pass through your galaxy and planetary system to arrive and encompass all of the Earth in one single moment, reaching all living within the planet at the same time. Gaia and all of her inhabitants will be able to see and feel the event, and not a single person will remain unaffected afterwards. What is likely to happen during the event? During the event, all incarnate souls will feel a powerful, undeniable surge of the following feelings all mixed in together: unconditional love, divine bliss, complete acceptance of who you are, divine grace, blessings, and strong feelings of finally being home again. During this powerful energy surge, some of you will be able to witness the appearance of an ascended master, which could be Yeshua, could be the Buddha, could be Krishna. Those are the ascended masters. You've probably seen a lot of 333s, which I have. I've been seeing a lot of 555s. I've been seeing a lot of 1111. Eve on license plate. Saw Isis on a name tag last week. Oh, the list goes on. 222s, a lot of 222s, which is also the energetic balances as well. 333 is also what's coming into alignment with the Holy Trinity, as one would say, as well as the ascended masters. And also everything is in divine order as well. That's what that also means. So at the time when you do see the repeated numbers, look them up because there is a specific message for you. Yes, there is. So it says here, during this powerful energy surge, some of you will be able to witness the appearance of an ascended master, leaders, founders of the religious faith that you believe in or have a close spiritual connection with. For example, if you're a Christian, you may see a vision of, have you been seeing 1, 2, 3, 4 a lot? Usually when you see 1, 2, 3, 4, it means that you're accelerating in consciousness, so you're accelerating with something in your life that you've begun, and then it's just shifting on, you know, on higher level and higher level. If you've been seeing the numbers frequently, that's when you know it's time to look it up. So say, for instance, if it's not subjected to just 2, 2, 2s and 3, 3, 3s, you could be seeing 3, 1, 3, and then all of a sudden you're just seeing it often. You're like, why am I seeing 3, 1, 3 often or 2, 1, 2 often? That's when it's time for you to look up the numbers. But I know when the numbers are in sequential order of 1, 2, 3, 4, it shows what's accelerating for you. Okay. And in some cases, there's some people who might have deceleration of numbers. It doesn't mean that it's something bad. It just means that it's time for you to pay attention to where, like say for instance, you're awakening to something that you know, and you decide to go in more into a 3D perspective of it, meaning that you're staying in anger, you're staying in frustration, you're bitter about it, you're whining, complaining, bitching about it, okay? And you're not only trying to look at it from a greater perspective to move through it, then you might end up seeing the numbers going downwards, 4, 3, 2, 1. Like I said, it doesn't mean that it's something bad happening. It just means that it's to get your attention. Your own, your higher self is trying to get your attention for you to take the opportunity to shift. Because that's what this is. This is an opportunity for you, just like equal employment in a way, but you're not being employed. Okay. This is not about working to make money. This is about manifesting things in your life that don't necessarily need to acquire money. How you're able to bring two different worlds together, having multiple experiences with that, and not necessarily manifesting something in just one order or just one way. Okay. So now, says here, if you are, for example, if you're a Christian, you may see a vision of Lord Jesus and you'll be able to talk to him personally. If you're a Buddhist, you may see a vision of Siddhartha Gautama, the Buddha, and be able to have a private conversation with him. You will instantly be able to recognize who you are by the very powerful light and loving vibrations that emanate. Even after reading what is written above, it will be challenging for most of you to even imagine what the event will feel like, because you do not have a previous life experience as a starting point of reference to compare it from within this lifetime. Because remember, I've always said in all my lives and everything, some of the things that we're experiencing and having is not and has not been written, has not been experienced before. And that's why we must stay present. We must stay in the now. Stay in the now and not just stay stuck in the past or, oh, well, it didn't happen this way like it was written. Because spirit wants you to stay focused on the now and what's being shown to you now and not just the past. Okay, so now it says here, as a starting point of reference to compare it from within this lifetime. However, some of you reading this, have had experienced something similar to the event during your meditation, spiritual awakening, but in a much smaller scale. If you belong to the latter of this group, that whatever you had previously felt in the past, you will feel all of the above feelings again, but magnified more than 1,000 times during the coming event. What will happen to everyone after the event, however, is where it gets a little bit tricky to explain. And as far as how I feel, I don't feel like, say, after the event, all of a sudden, something's going to shift where you're not feeling things anymore. It's going to be ongoing. So I just don't feel like as if, oh, gee, this is the end. Because even after we go through the spring equinox, which of course represents the spring with changes and also bringing the inner feminine and the inner masculine together, both in the energetic inner part of yourself and external part, we're also going to be heading into we're gonna have the summer solstice that's gonna be coming up, and I think there's another another eclipse for this year. So you see, no matter what, the energies are going to continue to support us, and that's the word I'm going to use. The energies are going to continue to support us to do it, what we are to continue to shift and to change and to alchemize as we are on this path to becoming golden, as we are bringing in the golden age. It's already happening. Okay, So now it says here, it gets a little tricky. Every one of you will perceive and process the event differently, depending on the type of soul group you belong to among the four different soul groups below. Now, I know in my soul group, which includes everyone who's listening to this, anyone who's come across this at any point in time, sevens. How many of you have been seeing the sevens also? Sevens, 717, 17. I saw 17 a lot yesterday, today, in the weirdest way. Like, I got a mail today and something that says, oh, we have 17 things here for you. I'm like, oh my God, everywhere, 17, 17, 17. Okay, so when you see the sevens and the 17, that is what shows you, what is showing as the elements of the soul group. And what's coming together within the soul group. Because even within the soul group, which I call it your soul family, that's a part of what is coming into union. It's not just to do with your twin, but also who is within your soul group. You may find yourself being in more conversations, connecting to people in your soul group, comparing notes, you know, whatever comes together in unison. That's a part of this cycle. Okay, so now... here says here what will happen in these different soul groups. Group one consists of awakened souls, our light workers, all of you who are, she says, reading this, I'm going to say hearing this. You will know and understand the event as what it truly is. It is the great catalyst that will simultaneously mark the beginning of Nova Gaia, Utopia Earth, and mark the end of times, the end of life as you've previously known it, the third dimensional Earth, which you know what that is, as I've spoken before. The end of times meaning the end of structures, ways that you live, think, feel, believe, attach to, all of that stuff, okay? You have been awakened earlier than most of humanity for a very important reason. You have been entrusted to be the guides, the way showers, and the leaders of fifth dimensional living, because we are no longer going to be living in a third dimensional state on the earth. It is where we're vibrating and living in the fifth dimension and more. There are some of us who are already vibrating in the seventh dimension, the ninth dimension. I've gone up even higher dimensions. I cannot begin to tell you how far I've gone, and I have to come right back down as I continue to template and bring in all these frequencies and these codes and all of this. So, and some, like I said, so everyone is on different paths and different levels with this journey. Be kind to yourself, be gentle with one another. And if you need to speak up, of course, you still do that. That's very important, because people think that when you're on this spiritual religious path that you're supposed to be passive, and oh, it's ungodly or it's not spiritual if you cuss or if you say this. Let me tell you something. If you do not allow yourself to release the feelings and how you feel, however you choose to express it, you know what? That's a part of going against yourself. That's a part of being fake and not authentic. I keep it real. I will always keep it real. I'll keep it real today, tomorrow, the next day, always, and continue. And you know what? I feel great within myself because of that. That's a part of being authentic. I'm not saying if you have to cuss means that... if you do it all the time, what does it do to you or to do to someone that's an offender? Something, it's words. It carries energy. We're changing words. We're shifting vibration. I already asked God and I said, you know, when we go to the new earth, are we going to still have to be cussing? And Spirit says, if you choose, but then I won't have anybody really irking my nerves or me having to have to be like I'm defending myself, which I don't do that anymore. I don't defend myself anymore. I just leave it as it is. I don't have to allow myself anymore to feel like I have to justify and explain my path, who I am, what me say, what me do. Me don't talk it already. Me don't even like to talk and explain over and over again because it gets to be boring. How many of you out there are bored already and you're ready for the new exciting stuff that's happening? This is where I'm at right now. All I'm saying is, however you choose to express yourself, do that. If you feel you can't express yourself to the person how you feel, write it down on paper. If it's something negative, burn it. If it's something you want to release to help you, do that. It is serving you in a greater sense by being and doing that, okay? There's no law, book, and book rule that if you don't do this, you're not spiritual. If you don't do this, you're not a Christian. Oh, that's ungodly. Please, 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 please. Okay, that's all programming again. And all this programming is already like truly just coming out. It's just releasing. You know, and I know for some people it's like, oh my God, what's going on? What's going on? How come this person now do this and this? This is what I'm saying. This is what I'm saying. Because you know what? There's people who do things and say things behind closed doors. And I'm saying there's some things that will remain private. But if you know that there's something bothering you and something you're going through that is making you feel disempowered, or someone is making you feel indifferent, or it's not an acceptance of who you are. Because you see, it still reflects something within you, because this is about you accepting who you are and still giving no fucks what somebody has to say, truly, okay? Because if you have any to give, then you're disempowering yourself, okay? Truly, that's what this is, and I'm just keeping it very real. You wanna lighten up yourself, then you let go and you allow yourself to keep, you know, being yourself and being in your truth and being in your knowing, because your journey and what you have as far as your relationship with the divine, your relationship with God is between you and God, is between you and that person that you share that same soul frequency. That does not have to be explained to anyone else, you see? And if anyone else is judging you based on that path, that's with for themselves to resolve. Because it's none of your business how they want to think about it. It's all your business. And you stay within your lane and stay within your power. And this is both on the feminine aspect and the masculine aspect. Because I know that for some, especially for with a lot of those who are carry a lot of the masculine frequency, that old patriarchal control energy, It's dying away. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. And it's about you honoring yourself and being in control of your life, being authentic, moving on and moving forward and propelling forward as what is a representation of the true divine masculine. And that means that you're not staying or being in denial anymore of your path. And your gifts and the gifts that you know that you share with your divine counterpart, okay? Whether you're on the feminine side or the masculine side, because it is still coming together. This is a part of the soul journey and where your soul is taking you. And anything that's in resistance of that is, like I said, your world and everything around you is going to keep presenting itself that shows up as either chaos or heaviness or any of that. Okay, and I can see already how much changes have been happening dramatically with especially a lot of males, and more honor being given to the feminine. You know, all of that also too, I've been noticing and seeing as part of these shifts and changes that are happening. And that's why the spring equinox represents what's coming together from the sun. The solar represents male energy, to, you know, coming together with the feminine energy. And it's like, again, that rubber band effect, you know, you pull the rubber band and no matter what, it's going to snap back together. It doesn't matter what's happening in the 3D perspective with that person. You know, they're just going to find themselves. I've heard two different male twins had indicated that they just picked up the phone, made a call to their divine feminine counterpart. And like I said, it could be both ways. And they didn't even realize that it was happening because the soul, this God frequency, this energy is propelling things to happen at an accelerated rate. And it is important for even more of these divine units to come together that's templating on the earth because of what is representing in on a massive scale, especially because so many more of these structures are starting to break down. And so there's more who are being put in place in order to keep things aligned in its truth and authenticity. You know, like in other words, say for instance, with the banking system, you know, they're trying to bring in a new monetary system. And so anything that's trying to stop the new one, though we're holding light. We're holding light and we're holding that space that even if someone tries to diffuse it, we're still speaking it. And it's so strong now and powerful now, it cannot be stopped. It cannot be stopped. It's already happening. It's already going on. Okay. So I just wanted to share, you know, that information. I'm so thankful that Spirit reminded me to talk about what was happening with the master, because I also, they reminded me again. I also had a dream. This had to do with my own divine compliment, where I dreamt something to do with him about 2 weeks ago, I think it was, or a week ago, I don't remember. And there was one that I had with my twin also, where he was just becoming more stronger within himself. And it's like he was speaking up. He was, you know, there was more details to the dream, but I'm just giving you just like the overall energy, what was happening. And I was processing because I was in the bathroom in a dream, and he was just showing me how he was like at a stage where he was like, fuck it. That's it. That's how it came in the dream to me, and staying strong within himself and strong within his own power and his own truth, what he desires and what he's here for. Okay, so that's what was being shown to me in the dream, and it had to do with what was being resurrected. Okay, because you know that the this month also we're in the what they call the Lent season, and we're also in this energy of the death. You know, the Good Friday, the death. And the rebirth, the death and the rebirth, the resurrection, how we are now becoming resurrected within ourselves and becoming new galactic beings, how we are shifting with this frequency and becoming more empowered. Because, you know, when Yeshua was on the planet and he went through the ascension process, it didn't go all the way. And now this is the time where we're really truly going to be seeing and experiencing this going all the way and then some, and also continuing, and what it is doing for us and what it's doing for the earth. And like I said, there's no clear picture as far as what it's going to look like, but I do know that we're going to be having more shifts with everything physically around us, as well as with our bodies, how we think, and being in a higher state of love where it's more long lasting. Because I know what it's like when we're in that higher grand feeling of love, and then it went away, you know, and it's like, no, I didn't want it to go. That's why most people who leave out of their bodies, they don't want to come back, because you, when you're in that ascended state, you're feeling the glory and the oneness of everything and everyone. And it's such an overwhelming high feeling, like you feel high. And you feel so, oh my goodness, you know. And then what usually happens when you start to feel it in the within your physical body, then that's when all the other stuff, the opposite starts to happen. Things start to break down. But now, how Spirit is showing it to me, you may be feeling like you're, and then within about after 3 days or so, you're going to start to feel things start to break down around you. You know, you might have emotional stuff start to come up. You may have some pain of things start to come up, some physical things around you start to, you know, go haywire and crazy. Your twin might pull away from you again, or you might not hear from them. You have to know that, you know, the energy that's coming between you and your twin is that you come together, and then things will fall apart, whatever shows up as a mirror for you to heal. Because, you know, I'm just saying this as a general thing and not, you know, subjected to something specific. And then what happens is you come into that space of healing within yourself, and your solar plexus starts to come through even greater healing, because we are healing a lot that has been shifting with our solar, solar plexus, the root chakra. All of this stuff is what's being recalibrated as well. And being able to feel that connection and coming from the heart space. And it's not just, oh, I'm just physically with someone and I'm going to have sex with them. No, this is about what's coming together. Everything with the entire body, having that full experience, that full body orgasm, that's the true higher state of connected to God, having that full, because it's a sexual energy. It's an energy that comes forth with the body, heart, mind, and soul. And that's like when you're really online on this grid, and that's what propels things to come into a greater manifestation. And as each one of us start to activate that parts of ourselves that comes together with all of this, with the love, the power, the strength, the unity, consciousness, and as this is connecting with your divine counterpart or parts, then what happens is this starts to stay even more templated on earth. And that's when you start to see the leaves on the trees start to look brighter. Spirit showed me how it's like they were showing me like things start to become golden on the earth, you see. And this is when everyone and everything, more people are vibrating and coming together in unison. And like I said, we're all placed on different parts of the earth on these grids as we are trying to clear shift. Then those who are around us, you know, family, friends, whoever is still among us, that is a part of this soul, you know, evolution, part of their soul family. As we are integrating and pulling this together, because the unity, the unison, the union, it's the inner union and the external union, and then the union of others, and then the union of the earth, the union of the cosmos, the union of the galaxies, everything together. Just like that movie, Guardians of the Galaxy, true, okay? So I just wanted to share that with you. I'm glad I didn't forget, okay? So now we've been training and preparing for this moment for a very long time, and are now completely ready to take up the mantle of leadership and be the teachers, mentors, trainers you have come here to be. Because many of us are here to be trainers and leaders to help those who are going to start to awaken even more, and to help them on their path of understanding what their journey is all about, what it means, where it's taking them. The role that you will assume after this great event will be revealed to you in greater depth and clarity by your higher calling, and have begun already settled into these light work roles anyway by now in some way, shape, or form. You will be leaders of the fifth dimensional way of life and will receive constant guidance and direct assistance from your galactic brothers and sisters from many highly evolved advanced civilizations. You will enjoy the lessons these galactics will provide to help with the planetary healing of Gaia, as well as the formation of Nova Earth. Many new fifth dimensional structures are now ready to be put into place, and your spiritual powers will be fully awakened and start to develop at a faster rate. You will learn how to master your thoughts, since humanity will soon be a race of beings who predominantly communicates via telepathy. Mastering your thoughts is the first step to mastering the art of creation and manifestation, and your galactic brothers and sisters will greatly help you on this as well. And when your lessons with them are complete, you will then go out into the world to share this knowledge with others, so that all humans on planet Earth will one day be the living embodiment of their higher selves. All will become powerful creators and manifestors. Earth will become a planet that only consists of loving beings who truly embody oneness and unity, of masterful beings who have ascended to the fifth dimension. Group 2 consists of unawakened souls who at a higher level have decided to ascend in this lifetime. The event will trigger tremendous shock, confusion, and cause them to initiate research into greater understanding on what exactly has happened to them. The event can be likened to the loudest wake-up call they have ever heard in their entire lives, one that can no longer be ignored. They will start with a sense of deep urgency that only they can feel, to seek and attract into their possesses the higher knowledge needed to help them move forward in their own great path of light. Spiritual development will become their main focus in life, and with time, as they grow more spiritually mature, these souls will come into a full remembrance of their true higher selves and strive to embody divine love in their everyday lives. Group 3 consists of unawakened souls who at a higher level have decided not to ascend in this lifetime. They will still feel the intensity of the great event and also experience all the feelings that come during it. However, after it is over, they will slowly return to life within the third dimensional paradigm. Even if they were to come across real and authentic news about the event and what it signifies, their inner reaction will be strong doubts, disbelief, and denial. The event is the greatest wake-up call to all incarnate souls on planet Earth who are currently still sleeping. This group of souls, however, is sleeping too deeply and have at a higher level decided not to wake up in this lifetime. Thus, the event will not trigger any interest in all things spiritual, as they are not at the phase where spiritual development becomes a priority. In other words, they are not mentally, physically, emotionally, and spiritually ready to ascend right now in this current lifetime. Group 4 consists of unawakened souls who at a higher level have decided to play the roles of the dark in this lifetime. If you haven't already done it, please read the message titled Embracing the Dark for more information about this particular group of souls. There are two types of the darks in this particular soul group. One that is in the know of what is happening on Earth right now, and another who is completely in the dark and have no idea, care about the event and what it means. Those who are in the know, who have so far actively and deliberately tried to prevent and stop the spiritual program of humanity, progress of humanity, will come to a sudden realization that their time has now come to a complete end. They will know that all is lost for their dark purpose, cause as humanity will no longer hold any interest in living in the type of lower vibrational, third dimensional consciousness these darks thrive on. All the souls in Group 4 will be faced with only two possible paths to undertake after the great event. Path A is the path of a possible return to the light and love of their higher selves. This is a path that offers one final last chance for these souls to embrace the light and return to their divine origin in this current lifetime. For the souls who are choosing this, great courage is needed to walk the path. They all have to come clean with the wrongs that they had done in their current lifetime, you know, clearing karma, whatever you want to call it, and in all things that have been harmful to the planet and are harmful to people, groups, societies, citizens of their own countries. All will be disclosed anyway in one way or another. Nothing can remain hidden in Nova Gaia. Every human being on the planet will one day find out all the wrongs that have been done to them by this group of souls whose previous purpose was to have power over others and satisfy their greed. Every harmful action they have ever been a party of, either directly or indirectly, will come under intense scrutiny. Spiritual leaders from soul groups, one from all across the world, will be selected to come forward and represent humanity, to decide what to do with all the souls in Group 4 who have decided to walk Path A. If you are selected to be one of these spiritual leaders, and many of you reading this or hearing this, please remember what was said in the end of the last statement, was that you're called to be the voice of reason, the voice of love. You will be called to be the anchors of a fifth dimensional way of being, the way of unconditional love. You will be the voice of calm, the voice of peace. You will speak and stand up in front of many citizens of Earth and persuade them to choose the way of unconditional love, the way of forgiveness, and the way of letting go of the past. These leaders will first have to access the true intention of all who belong to Group 4. There must be true remorse, a genuine intention to reform, and a willingness to surrender to the decisions of not only the selected spiritual leaders, but also the group of people that they had harmed in the past. The leaders will have the ability to detect all deceits and lies there they may be given by some of these souls. A deliberate attempt to deceive and lie will definitely fail in the event where some of these souls' true intention is just to, one way or the other, escape the consequences they're being forced to face. Only those with the most genuine of intention to make amends, reconcile, and pay for their mistakes and adopt the fifth dimensional way of living in the spirit of love, unity, peace, and abundance for all will eventually be forgiven, embraced, and continuously guided so that they will once again walk the path of the one living in the light. After going through the above assessment, if when it is found that some souls are so lost in the dark that nothing further can be done to return them back to the path of light, it will likely be Group 4 souls who are in the know. Then Path B is the only option these souls can undertake. No other path will be allowed. Path B is where souls will have to be returned and merge back into the light of source, which I have, that was shown to me, you know, what will happen, because it's not where we're going to have to be policing anyone and saying, oh, you did this, oh, you're going to go. No, this is about we're in our sovereignty and everyone is taking responsibility for their actions and their thoughts. And so back to God's loving's arms, to a different third dimensional planet that still supports duality, fear, lack, and separation consciousness. That's what will happen with those souls who choose to just remain, you know, doing harm to others. That's the type of dark we're talking about, not the one where you're in ignorance, you know, because there's also darkness when someone is in ignorance, where they're lacking intelligence, lacking wisdom and knowledge. And then there's a dark energy with those who are choosing to be, you know, with hurting others deliberately, you know, and stuff like that. That's a different story. That's the type of darkness that is being written here. And so there is one important point to remember here, that God has given each soul the free will to do whatever it wishes with the life he or she has given. There's no judgment, no condemnation. Every single soul who currently belongs to group four has pre-birth at a higher self level decided whether to follow the path of A and ascend now in this lifetime, or path B and ascend later in the future lifetimes elsewhere once they become ready. Your job, all of my beloved light workers, is currently reading this or listening to this, is to lead and live by example. You must be one of the first ones to step up and show your willingness to embrace, forgive, and let go of all the wrongs of these souls in group four path A. And in other words, it's almost like saying you're holding that space of unconditional love, knowing and understanding that they too still serve their purpose, because the more anyone is still staying on that path of doing harm to others, it also brings in something within you to keep awakening, to the truth, to keep awakening to who you are. Also, you're making a choice as far as the path that you're taking, and knowing that it helps to bring people together. It's just like if someone is doing harm to someone in particular, and it caused an uproar, then usually that incident in and of itself, it causes everyone to come together and make changes, okay? So even the person who's doing the most vilest thing, they're still serving their purpose. And the only thing is that once things start reaching to a certain level in the scheme of things, then they will have a choice to now dissipate, to stop what they're doing, to make a different choice, be on a different path. And if they still insist, you know, because the frequencies are not going to stop anymore and say, oh, let me just wait. Oh, let me just see if they get it at this point. No, it's continuously happening. And so they're going to be able to, they're just going to be brought, absorbed back by the light of God. And then they're going to just incarnate on another planet like Earth that still goes onto this frequency of lack and limitation and separation consciousness, the fear factor, you know, all these things. Okay. So this in and of itself, from what I read, is, like I said, it's an explanation of what is happening here, where it's taking us in this time, as what they call it, the event and the solar flares. And she says here too, in the case of the timing of this great event, however, the risk of a misprediction is magnified a millionfold. There are many micro and macro factors coming from the human collective that can influence space and time to produce a different timeline. Because, you know, we're all in different timelines. Some of us may be projecting certain things to occur in our lives. Some things might be held back because it's not the right timing between you and that individual or individuals. And so as things come together in a synchronistic way and synchronizing and coming in stronger, and how you'll know and feel that, because I know some people say, well, how will I know? How will I feel it? How will I really, really have an idea of the fact that it is happening? You will feel the changes in your body. You will start to feel the ascension feelings. You will feel the heaviness in your body as well. You'll start to feel that as well. And that will kind of even give you a greater idea of the fact that the elements of this solar thing is taking effect even more, and other things, because like I said, it's not subjected to just the solar event. So anyway, I'm going to just, I'm going to say like a little meditating. As I am so grateful to Mother and Father God for the messages that come forth in this time and space as we go from one element of these new beginnings and endings and the left, the right, all of this, all of the duality, everything that has been in separation is now coming and integrating the light, the dark, the sun, the moon, the stars. Heaven on earth is what we are bringing here, bringing forth right now. Yeti shakuni mira bishiketa da kinu ira bishiketa da kusilo meti shiketa da sito pushubita para pa. And as we are continuously walking through this path, as we are coming together as one, that we are now able to relate to one another with this as inner peace. As we start to relate to one another and how we are co-creating, and we are connecting more to this God consciousness and coming through the space of our heart, how we are connecting to one another telepathically, how we're coming together with these and within these divine unions as they're templating more and more and grounding onto the earth, and that we're also getting coming through with these visions and everything that's being restructured within our DNA. I'm forever grateful for the divine wisdom that is flowing through each and every one of us, that is permeating through every cells of our body, and that any of those who are vibrating to any type of illnesses, that they are in that space and knowing of coming into their own healing and knowing what is happening with their bodies, and also being less resistant to whatever is happening. Helping those who are also experiencing loved ones who are transitioning and going through what we call the cycles of death and coming into rebirth. And I am in just a space of gratitude with each and every one of you. I am thankful for love, as love continues to permeate through each and every one of us, this higher state, this higher divine love, in knowing that everything and all things that we are creating now, that it's in its perfection. It's in its perfection. As we are seeing ourselves as our mother and father in heaven and on earth sees us as perfect. Many of you are going to start to have even more visions and dreams, so begin to write them down. Begin to, put them somewhere in a recording or something, because it's all coming together collectively is what Spirit is saying right now. There's still going to be a cycle of changes when it comes to eating and what you're eating. Start to eat even more live foods or foods that are, not foods that are processed. Try to eat less foods that are processed and that are more in a natural state. Or high alkaline protein foods. Lots of water. If you can, to connect outside to Mother Earth with the sun. The rays of the sun will bring more clarity. Allow yourself to rest when necessary and to lay down. And not to be in any fear, as we are continuing through this entire year of rebirth. And that's what I'm hearing. So I don't know if anyone has any questions. I know I've been on 3 hours now. I think it was 3 hours, 6, 7, 7, 8. No, almost 3 hours. And I am grateful to be able to give them, because it has been quite a while since I've been on here as far as speaking on what's happening, and I'm going through my own shifts, like I said, and it has been powerful for me. Yes, it has, and it has been mind opening, and I know that when I see how things are happening, we don't have to worry about anything going against us or any negative, as we think with negative. Just stay in as much of a space of positive thoughts. Even when I was going through something so serious last week and I brought myself to the comedy show, I allowed myself to laugh. I allow myself to dance. I allow myself to, to be in that silly energy, as one would say, the silliness, the joy, because it helped me to feel better. And I tell you, what helped me to shift out of it completely at that moment was because I was watching Charlize do her live with her rapping. And it's like, it just brought a smile on my face. And not just a smile on my face, but I just felt whatever energy that was so heavy within me was just coming out. You're welcome, Diamond. It was just coming out. And so I'm in gratitude of that, because even our children are ascending with us at the same time. They too are going through their own energetic shifts. And it's, like I said, it's integrating. And the children, what I heard is that especially those between the ages of 12 and 14 are going to have even more divine messages that they are giving, because they already know what's happening and they're not in any fear. They already know what's happening on the planet. And because of that, they are also leading the way to what is happening intergalactically. Because I did see someone I did a reading for where her galactic son was in the room, and she said she does hear noises in that room, and she told that energy to go back to the light. And I joked and I said, nope, your galactic son is saying no, he's here to stay and to just embrace it, because there's divine messages that are coming through and what he's doing. I just see him typing on the computer. So it was very powerful, very, very powerful. And some parents are going to find their children from that age, they're going to be in their own sovereignty, where they may walk out and go be with a family that is vibrating to their frequency. So it's just like when Jesus walked the earth, he left his parents and he was only 12. And he told his parents, he said, I'm here to do God's work. I'm here to be on my path. And that's exactly what it's going to be like. And that's going to be like a shock to some parents, where their children are being guided to be elsewhere. And those rules that, oh, you're only an adult by such an age, but they're very advanced souls. So I just wanted to, give that information as well, as far as that is concerned. So just drink some water. I haven't drank so long. And so as we are connecting more to who we are, the galaxies, the universe, I just leave you with some music, that will remain in our hearts and souls, because it's even through the music that we receive the messages. And just allow yourself to feel the peacefulness that comes through as who you are, as the flowers of the universe, and knowing who you are, powerful. And we dumb down ourselves, and now we are bringing ourselves not only back up, but also bringing it in more solidified. See? And so you are the flower of the universe. You are a child of the Most High. I'm the daughter of the Most High. You are the son and then the daughters of the Most High God. And now there's a greater interest in this piece of who you are as it comes together. It is through the darkness that you remember yourself. It is through the dissension of yourself that you remember who you are. See? Yes. Inhale. This love is far and wide. Inhale and exhale. And everything's just will start to make sense. Yes. Song that comes after this is I Believe. I Believe. There's been so many children's songs that talk about, I believe, from Shrek. I believe, I believe, I believe. Believe in you. Believe in the divine and believe in your path. Yes, there's times when we may stray off of that path, just like Alice did, just like Dorothy did. But remember, we all desire to come back home. We all desire to come back home, and home is where the heart is. And just imagine what this is going to be like when we are just coming together in a grandest way. Because that's what's happening now. It's already happening. Yes. All those days of suffering. No. Not supposed to suffer. Find your way. Power in the tongue. Yes, I am, I am. No fear. She talks about the rainbow. You can do anything, be anything. Yes. You are grander than you could ever imagine. This is what we've been waiting for. I got interrupted by my thought-in-law. Stretch. I can, I will, I will. No fear, no fear. Now I'm gonna stand up. Yes. I saw a rainbow in the rain, how it comes together. Yes. I believe in me. The lotus flowers are blooming. I see many, many of them. Yes. Wearing our crowns. Yes. Victorious. You don't need no weapons. Just love. Love is a very powerful, powerful mechanism. Even as I'm talking now, I can't even hear out of my right ear. Like I'm feeling all this energy flowing. I believe in me, and I believe in you. I believe in us. Be inspired and allow things to keep unfolding. Surrender and stand up at the same time. Yes. Yes. A wrinkle in time. Go see that movie as well. Lots of messages from that movie as well. I believe in me, and I believe in all of us with all of this. Yes. Yes. Greetings. And the next one, last but not least, Warrior. I love this song. It just brings out something more in me of who I am. We are. Yes. You're invited to become the warrior of your life. Not to fight. Just being in that true power and strength. You see? Look at that. It's nighttime. And I'm still here. Be a warrior. I can be a warrior. Thank you so much for joining me. I love this. Music. Always listen to the words and see what is being spoken as the message.
No need to worry. Close your eyes. Yes. It is through closing your eyes where you find your imagination. It is through the imaginary, it's another new word, in which we become creative. And we start to look younger and feel great within ourselves. Inside, I'm alive. See? You never died, just regenerated. Yes. So you're in a great time now to be able to be a witness of this great time on earth. Yes. It's time to find your muchness again. Yep. Remember from Alice in Wonderland, to find that muchiness. You know, the Mad Hatter said, where is that muchiness? I know. Inside your life. Nothing, no powers or anything can separate us ever again from the true love of God. And know that. I love each and every one of you, and I'm grateful. Find yourselves and find this warrior energy within you as we are manifesting our true selves. Love you.